right, hello everyone, and peace of Christ to all of you. Please invite your friends. And today we have a very important topic. You know, the Muhammadan, they have tons of videos speaking about Muhammad. And for sure, all those videos are showing you how amazing this man is. I mean, come on. You have to accept that he is the best of the best. If you try to hide away from the truth, that Muhammad was the best of mankind, you will find a wall of videos in YouTube getting you busted. Actually, it's not only a wall, I mean, it's a long wall in YouTube. And all the videos made by Muslims are very truthful about Prophet Muhammad. So I said to myself, okay, well, they make videos about Muhammad. What those videos say? Shall we take a look? Let us take a look. Not this one, no. Hold on. Not this one, no. Hold on. Not this one, no. Hold on. So, come on, which one then? Come on. Let me see. Hold on. Which one we should take first? Okay, let us take this one. Because you see when they start talking about Prophet Muhammad, inside me, I feel like electricity, brother. Because it's just amazing. All right? So here, an example, a video is called, hold on. No, there's a commercial begging for money to build the Islamic Center as usual. Okay, 10 facts about Prophet Muhammad. What is the 10 facts?
Around the world, but who exactly is a Prophet Muhammad? And what are some of the...
I like when he say Muhammad. I mean, come on, man. It sounds like you are doing something. Go ahead.
Key events in his life that have made him such a central figure within the Muslim religion.
He got... I mean, look at this idiot. Muhammad became a... What make him... I mean, this guy is the maker of Islam, and what make him essential. You know, this is a very wonderful video from the beginning. You know, genius.
Guys, welcome back to another episode of FTD Facts. My name is Leroy Kenton. And yeah. Also welcome...
Your name is Lori. You mean we're in a truck. You are a truck loaded with poo-poo.
To any of you who are watching FTD Facts for the first time.
Okay,
in this episode, I'll be exploring 10 surprising and interesting facts about the Prophet Muhammad. Uh-huh. So make sure you watch all the way until the end because I don't want you to miss any of these
details. We cannot miss any for sure. Come on. Good. Go ahead. Tell us first one.
Details. Muhammad is the central prophet and final prophet of Islam.
We don't know that. Thank you for telling us. I'm really surprised. So this is the surprising fact. I'm surprised. You know, when I make a video like those videos, you see them in YouTube, the funny, stupid ones, like somebody watching a video about something like miracle in the Quran, and he opens his mouth like, whoa! You know, look, I know. The first reaction for first time Filipino eating hamburger, and that guy, he opened the camera and like he's now biting hamburger, American hamburger. You have to be careful, it's American hamburger. And like the camera is on him and like millions of people have to see this. I mean, come on. The first time a Filipino eating American hamburger. So now this is the first time we see the 10 surprising facts about Muhammad. And what the first one, he's a prophet. Okay. I'm surprised.
He was born in Mecca.
What the heck? He's born in Mecca too? Okay. I'm surprised.
In 570, and most of his early life was...
Are you sure it's 570?
...spent as a merchant. At the age of...
He was a merchant? Are you sure too?
40, that's when he began to have revelations.
At the age of 40, he got begun. Oh, that is number 10. And this is surprising facts. What are the facts?
From Allah that became the basis for the Quran.
Shouldn't you tell us who is Allah? He received revelation from Allah. No, Muhammad, he received revelation from Jibreel. We know that one from Allah. Where is Allah? Allah never spoke to Muhammad. Continue.
As well as the foundation of the Islamic religion. Uh-huh. By 630, he had unified most of Arabia under a single religion. Mm-hmm. And the Prophet Muhammad had a huge influence in the world. And we have evidence of this because...
Okay, no, get the crap. You are a stupid idiot. And you have nothing to say just to make videos and get the support of Muslims so you can make money from the commercial. Let us show you
the
true facts about Prophet Muhammad. Number one fact, and nobody can deny it. Muhammad needed a plastic surgery to fix his stupidity. Let us go to the hadith. That is the true facts. Everything else they say to you is stupid. And this is a fact reported by Muhammad. Here Muhammad is telling us a story about Allah sending two angels. And those two angels took Muhammad and they practiced a surgery for him. Yesterday in the previous video we spoke about this, but for sure for those who are here first time, we will talk about it again. Now, the story here, it says, just to make it short and because we have to make a review of the details, that there is two angels came to Muhammad. One of them is Jibreel. And those angels took him, you know, and put him in a table beside the well of Zamzam. And then from then, Jibreel took charge. So now in charge Jibreel, Mr. Jibreel. Okay, what Jibreel do? Like there's many things you know about Jibreel, that he's an angel. Jibreel is the pizza boy. He delivered message and even including dishes to Muhammad. If you remember, when Muhammad, he says, I was the meek, was most weak person in sexual intercourse. What Allah he did, he called Jibreel to deliver for him a dish of kufta, shir kebab, you know. Muhammad, he ate it and his ping, you know, his penis was the most powerful man. He have the power of 40 men of people of heaven, which means 4,000 men of earth. Because every man in heaven, his penis will have the power of 100 men. Come on, Allah is all capable. You know, he's almighty. He can make your penis have such a power. So the Prophet Muhammad, after he received the dish from Jibreel, he got the power of 4,000 men. And this is very, very impressive. You have to admit, only Allah can do those things. You know, so Jibreel, he brought the dish and Jibreel brought Quran and Jibreel brought other things. And those things come in dishes too. Let us see. So Jibreel took charge of him and Jibreel cut open the body of Muhammad. Here Jibreel became a surgeon, Dr. Jibreel. He's an angel, yes. He bring food to Muhammad, yes. He deliver Quran to Muhammad, exactly. Absolutely. But now Jibreel today have a different mission. He is Dr. Jibreel. Allah, he sent Jibreel to do a surgery and he cut the chest of Muhammad. Cut it from here to here. Different hadith says from there to the pubic area. And you know, by the way, I understand. I mean, you have to go to the testicle of Muhammad to fix everything. Obviously, everything is messed up. So he cut from here to there. And here in the hadith translation saying between the throat and the middle of the chest, which is really absolutely false. You know, it's cut all the way to his balls, if he have any. And in the middle of his chest, okay, and then he took all the material out of his chest. Here we have to stop. Because you see, when you take the heart of somebody out, he die. Even if you take the liver, still he would die. I mean, what do you mean you took all the material out? So here we notice that Muhammad, he was the first object which lived by solar battery. Obviously, Jibreel hooked Muhammad to solar power, like he have a solar panel, you know, and he hooked Muhammad in somewhere, you know, whatever extension he have or hole, you know. So, because I want to know how this guy now is having all his material in his chest out, and Muhammad is the one is telling us what's happening. I mean, this guy, his eyes is open. And here we notice that when the Western, they come with this stupid system claiming that this is their discovery, the fact it was Muhammad obviously was living by the support of solar system, and this is what make Muhammad a solar prophet. Actually, the Quran says that Prophet Muhammad, he is a sirajan muniran. Sirajan mean he's a light. This is why the Shia, they say based on this verse, that the family of Muhammad, they are not a human, they are made of light, and they used to be, they used to be in stars in the forehead of Allah. If you go to chapter 33, verse number 46. So Muhammad is a lamp. And if you think about it, now Muhammad, he is a lamp, but now Jibreel, he took all the material from his heart, from his chest, his heart, his stomach, everything is out, you know. And not only that, he washed it with Zimzim. And here we notice something very important. You see, most of you, because you don't concentrate, you don't notice how important this is. Here it's proving that the material of Prophet Muhammad in his chest is different from our material. Because you can take it out and you can wash it with the water of Zimzim. Zimzim, according to the BBC study, it's a poisoned water. Each time you drink a cup of Zimzim, the Muslim even they sue the BBC for making such a report exposing the stupidity of Zimzim water, which is supposedly holy. Each time you drink a cup of Zimzim, as a drinking, I think, cigarette or two cigarettes or a box of cigarettes, I'm not sure. You can check the article. So now Muhammad stuff, his whatever he's having that drunk in his chest, all of it is out. And now Jibreel, he took it off for a reason. And this is what is making this story extremely smart. Actually, this story must be, I mean, Muhammad must be a genius to tell us such a story. Because now look at this. The guy is in a surgery. The angel is taking off his heart, his kidney, his liver, his stomach, his balls, whatever. And still Muhammad is watching. How he can see there? I mean, you are laying down. Oh, he left him in front of him. Maybe Jibreel, he was showing Muhammad exactly what he's taking off. Hey, Muhammad, this is your heart. Okay, Muhammad, this is your liver. Okay, Muhammad, this is your stomach. And Muhammad is have a very good memory, you know. So he remember all those details. So then he washed it with Zimzim. And here we need to understand that why he washed it in Zimzim. Why he did not go to a faucet in a, like in a bathroom somewhere. Why it was Zimzim. There's a very, very important reason. Because Zimzim is a holy water of Allah. Zimzim. Even the name, look, Zam and Zam, two Zam together. So it's not like one Zam, it is two Zam. And two Zam, that's mean like when you say H2O, so this is the H2. Okay? The O is something you say later when you see like, wow, like, you know, so Zamzam, you know? So he washed it with Zamzam and with his hand. Look, 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 here, we notice, come on, look at the details. Jibreel did not wash it with laundry machine. No, brother. He did not ask the other guy to wash it. No, brother. Jibreel is washing it with his own hands. You know what? I was afraid that he will do like those women when they do make wine. They put the things, or like in the villages, they put the laundry in the dish and they step on it. You know, like step in it, step in it, step in it. So that will make it like, you know, get it cleaner. So Jibreel did not do that. He did not step on the organs of Muhammad. He washed it with his hands. The funny is, Jibreel, he have 600 wings. But he have hands, you know. I don't know. It looked like just Jibreel. He's a transformer. You know what I mean? Like, what do you want? He have 600 wings. Look, I mean, 600 wings. So now what happened? The 600 wings, they became 600 hands. It's just a question, you know, I mean, you don't need to, if you are a Muslim, okay, I'm sure you have an answer. The scholars will tell you what happened. So the guy, he have 600 hands or 600 wings? Maybe because I am weak in Arabic, as the Muslim they say, maybe wings in Arabic is hands. So now if I go in the Middle East and if I see like, you know, a chicken, I can say to the chicken, let us shake hands. You know, I mean, a chicken, hey, can we shake hands, you know? So Muhammad, he is a person, he claimed things doesn't make sense with the previous things. When he want Jibreel is a man, when he want Jibreel is a person with 600 wings. And by the way, when he have 600 wings, what about the rest of the description? And what happened, his face is a face of what? So he have 600 wings, but he have a body of a man, elephant. Don't ask questions. Muhammad talking, everybody have to shut up. Now we go back to the hadith, which is a very authentic hadith, you know, and this prophet never, you see, the prophet never, never, never tell a lie. You have to always put that in your mind. If you want to live, at least, you know. I mean, if you don't want to go in the park, and by the way, I heard that the Abdul who attacked our sister, what her name, Hatun, he attacked her because she was place or wearing a cartoon something. You know, I have a message for you, Abdul. If you ever attack anyone again, I promise you, we will put the cartoon of Muhammad in every video. If you think you can intimidate us, if you think you can scare us, if you think you can stop us from saying what we believe by your stupid violence, you are mistaken. And not only men, actually many Christians agree that we should do that. So you will create a wave of cartoon for Muhammad by your stupid action. Do violence again and you will see. And actually not only that, if you do it again, I'm thinking to make a special series of cartoon. It's a message. Take it or leave it. Coward who attack a woman and run potato. At least stand up there. Muta boy. We go back here. So now the prophet of Allah, who is upon the man, about what? Upon the man, was washed by Zamzam. Okay. You know, I always ask myself, I mean, I don't even know how to say this word correctly. Excuse my English. You know, I mean, you know, English is not my first language. Even though I speak, by the way, I am the one who taught Shakespeare how to speak English, because Shakespeare is an Arab, by the way, and his real name is Sheikh Isper. I'm telling you, you know, his real name is Sheikh Isper, and I am the one who taught him English. Now, let us go to the abandonment. Okay, what is the abandonment? I mean, I want to see the abandonment. What is the abandonment? Let me see. I'm going to look in. In Google, which part is the abandonment? Abandonment. I don't know which one. Which one? Look here. See, I'm trying to find out the location of this thing, because obviously it's important for Jibreel. But which one? Anyone here is a doctor? The only doctor we have here, I mean, true doctor is Dr. Prophet Muhammad. Where is the abandonment? I don't see the abandonment. Where? I cannot find it. Hold on, let me see. Abandonment. I mean, I don't see one single picture saying which one. So is that the green one there? I don't know. I mean, what does that mean? Hold on. Okay, let's see here. We have, I guess maybe abandonment in English mean everything, the whole thing connected together. What is abandonment? Let me translate the word. I don't know really what the word mean. Because, you know, in the translation, they are getting you whatever they like. A body space between the thorax and chest. It's not a part really. Commonly called this is the Billy, Billy Jones, and I was looking for a part. I thought it's the name of a part or something. No, brother. So he took everything there. Look. Zibril, he took everything there. Everything, brother, everything. You see all those things in the screen? The answer, Zibril, he took it all, brother. And now you can imagine the smell. And now Jibreel is squeezing all the poopoo inside, you know, and he pushing it out, and everything came out. But I have a question to the Muslims. What is the purpose of this abandonment washing? Any Muslim can abandon. Stop looking at it. Come on, why you are laughing at my English? Shame on you. Okay, I'm going to, you know what? There's a person, he laughed at me. He woke up in the morning, looked like me. You want to have this happen to you? You don't do that. So look, what is making me really thinking deep, so focus with me with the deep thing. Why Jibreel is digging deep in the stomach of Muhammad and what he is supposed to trying to clean out there, like what we have there. I thought about what happened in Hiroshima, Nagasaki. Maybe there's some radiation. No, there was no at that time. Okay. Maybe Muhammad have some worms are eating his faith, because worms, they live there. Maybe. So the angel is cleaning what? If there is any Muslim can tell us what was the purpose of this? Are you trying to imply? Excuse my language. Where is everybody? Huh? Where is it? I think I made a mistake yesterday. I told you I will come Friday, right? And then it turned to be it's today. Unbelievable. Never make an appointment with an Arab guy. Here we go. Friday became Thursday. Thursday became Friday. Yeah, we learned that from Prophet Muhammad. He said the judgment day is near, and that's 1400 years ago. So why the Prophet, he is facing such a surgery, and why the angel is washing the material, as the hadith says, inside? Any Muslim can help us? To purify the Prophet. Oh, this is Christopher. He is a Muslim. He don't like to use a Muslim name, but he's a Muslim. Here we have a Muslim in the chat. Thank you, Mr. Christopher. I don't know why you call yourself a Christopher, but you are a Muslim, my friend. Shame on you. So look what he said. To purify the Prophet. That's deep. You know, I don't know why I cannot think straight like you. I mean, obviously there is something missing in my thinking. How you were able to come to this conclusion, Christopher? So to purify the Prophet, you have to wash his stomach? What about his anus? I want you to think about it. Because if you wash the stomach and the anus is not clean, I mean, there's many things will be there. Don't tell me no. So now we wash the stomach and all the material in his stomach. By the way, the abdomen go all the way connected to his anus. Do you think he took it off too? And why he need to purify his stomach? Mr. Christopher? Who is a Muslim he agree that actually he is trained with what Muslim believe, yeah, that they purify the Prophet. Okay, so now we have to purify the Prophet by washing his stomach. It is metaphorical. Well, if it's a metaphorical, that means all the story is false. Because there's a huge difference between happened and a parable. Was this a parable? No. Muhammad talking about two angels, they come and they did a real surgery. Even the Muslim, they claim that they saw the stitches. And those surgeries happened to Muhammad twice. Once when he was a kid, supposedly, and once when he was adult. So when you say it's a metaphorical, and we laugh, because your prophet said, and by the way, your name is Black Dog. Don't you know what the prophet said about Black Dog? I mean, you are a Muslim and you are calling yourself a Black Dog. Do you know that this is the most enemy to Allah, the Black Dog? you know, I don't know what to say. I mean, I learned a lot of things from your prophet, which is amazing prophet, by the way. Don't take me wrong, please. But when I learned that the black dog is the biggest enemy to Allah, and he is shaitan, you know, always I was thinking, why the black dog is black? First, I thought he is dyeing his hair. Because there's no way that the dog is black. Then it hit me, Prophet Muhammad Hadith. Right? Then call of duty. But this is not about call of duty, my friend. Don't talk about call of duty. Don't take me there. There's a hadith says that the Prophet, قَدْ عَلَّمَنَا كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَتَّى الْخَرَىٰ. The Prophet, he taught us everything, including how to shit. Do you want me to show you the hadith, Christopher? In the Old Testament, those are savage people. So he was telling them, you go and you do your business away from the camp. That's all. But your prophet, according to you Muslims, he used to sit and you sit around him and he teach you how to do poo-poo. Christopher, don't go there. But anyway, the black dog is a shaitan, brother. Since when? Any Muslim can tell us why the black dog is a shaitan? Scientifically, this is true. I mean, when scientists, they open the abdomen of dog, he is black. What they find inside? What they found inside? Evil. This guy, he eat evil. He don't eat like chicken and meat like everybody, hamburger. No. Black dog are shaitan, brother. Science. This is pure science. So Muhammad, he says, three things, four things, five things will interrupt a Muslim prayer. Okay, what is that, brother? What is that? A woman, a donkey, and a black dog. A brother, and why a black dog? Because a black dog is a shaitan. He is not only shaitan, he is the devil himself. Like he's not like a baby shaitan of a shit. He is the devil himself. And this is what Prophet Muhammad, you see this guy, he makes surprising fact about Prophet Muhammad. This is a surprising fact that Muhammad is the first one who discovered that the black color have to do with evil. And the dog, because he's black now, you see how racist this Muhammad is? The poor black dog, just because he's black, is the devil. He is the devil. Not devilish. He is the devil, brother. Discovery. Okay, now we go back to Christopher and his friend trying to defend his prophet. And you mentioned about the poo-poo. I will type the word shit, excuse my language, in the screen. Here we go. I did not search for a specific hadith. I just typed there the word al-khara. Khara means shit, excuse me. All right. A man, he came to a Muslim at the time of Muhammad, and he said to him, I see you're a friend, and this is mean Muhammad, teaching you even how to do shit. You see here, they say experiment. It doesn't, you know, it says literally in Arabic shit. And then the guy, he said, yes, the prophet, he do. And he taught us to use three rocks. Hey, Abdul, do you have three rocks in your bathroom or you are using the American toilet papers? Yeah. Chapter 50, verse number 38, God created a yam, proof of a miracle. Hey, we go there. Just remind me after we finish the topic, Christopher. Please promise me you will remind me. When I say I'm done with this, remind me, Christopher. You know, remind me of this so we go back and we laugh. So, you know, Christopher is a very specialist person, him and other Muslims. We talk about how this happened and they talk about miracle in the Quran. This is a miracle, don't you see? Shaitan is a black dog. And isn't this a proven a miracle for you? You are trying to change our topic, don't you? So this now, they wash his abdomen, because obviously Muhammad is full of poo-poo. And they wash it with Zamzam water with his own hand till he cleans the inside of his body. Which means not only he cleaned the material was there, took it off. No, he put water, washing the belly of the beast. Then here, now here we have the cake. This is the cake time. And then a golden tray containing a golden bowl full of belief. Hold on. As long. You see, usually if you search in Google, you find anything. I search for faith dish. Okay, hold on, let's go to Unsplash. And I will type the word dish. Okay. And in the word dish, like I found some food. So the angel brother, he did not come from Allah with dish of food this time. Previous dish, he brought shish kebab, Muhammad, he ate it to fix his penis. You remember that. Now the angel, he brought a dish, and the dish is full of faith and wisdom. I mean, I don't know how dumb is this story is, but you tell me. So now we will give a chance to the Muslim Christopher and the other guy and Muhammad Ishmael and all the Muslims here to tell us why the angel is bringing a dish full of faith and wisdom. Why Allah, he sent this dish? Because remember, the angel is doing service to Allah. It's not his choice. Why the angel, he brought a dish of faith and wisdom? Any Muslim can help us? Anyone? You know, when I was a kid, I told my mom, I don't want to eat. She said, so son, what do you want? I said, I want a dish of wisdom. That, she said to me, this is dumb. Like, you know, she offended me. You know, since when I decide not to eat her food. You know, that's it. True story, Sahih Bukhari. Any Muslim can tell us. Why Allah, he sending a dish, and this dish is full of belief. I want to stop with this belief thing. A dish full of belief. Believe me, this is a true story. Any Muslim can tell us? Listen. I don't know how many females we have in this room. Now, Muslims, they claim that women, they have half a brain and men have supposedly full brain, whatever, you know. But the reality is a different story, you know. A man, he see a short skirt, he lose all his brain. Anyway, so if you have a husband and he have, you know, his brain is not working, you know. I mean, eh. Or he don't have a belief, he's an atheist. Mm-hmm, you know, you never know. I got a recipe for you. Try to find what was in that dish, a dish of belief. Your husband eat it, became a believer, bingo. And if your husband is a fool, it says, look, a dish full of full. It's not half full. I mean, look at the tears, brother. It's not half full, it's full. This is what I like about Islam. It's full of details. To clean him from impurity. Look like Muhammad Ishmael, he received the question 2 hours ago and now he found the answer an hour after. Hey, Muhammad Ishmael, you remind me of someone. He heard a joke like a week before and he was laughing today. Now you're interested in this answer? You are late, my friend. Okay. So guys, why the Prophet, his abdomen taken off of his body to wash it. Muhammad Ismail, he gave us a clear answer. To clean him out of any impurities. Now Muhammad have nothing is impure inside him. Before that moment, Muhammad full of shit. This is what you are saying to me. And not only he is full of it, he needed a special surgery to clean it. Like you cannot take him like a drug, he eat it and he go to the bathroom, like it come out with diarrhea. No. It is so big and so tough to the point the angel have to cut open his belly and take all the material. Thank you, Muhammad Ismail. What I would do without you, Muhammad Ismail, honestly. I mean, how we can live without you, brother? Thank you for your wisdom. It's amazing wisdom. I need a dumb admin to be in my chat because we don't have any intent now. You like to be an admin, Muhammad Ismail? The dumb admin? You just confirmed to us that your prophet is full of it. It's a metaphorical. Look at those guys. They open his chest. He took the material. He cleaned it with water. Water is a metaphorical. Is cutting the chest. Is that a real story or fake story? You must then believe this has happened for real. So how is metaphorical? Anything is embarrassing to the Muhammadan. They say it's a metaphorical. Do you remember the guy who called me 2 days, 3 days ago? He said to me, I saw the video. You lied about the penis standing in the Quran. When I showed him the reference, he said, you have your religion, I have mine. He ran away. And he used the word metaphorical too. But the second we show it to him, it's a metaphorical. So they cut his chest, they brought a dish, they washed it with Zamzam. It's a metaphorical. So why the other guy, he says, to clean it from impurity, if it's metaphorical? This is how much confused they are. They cannot defend it. Stupid story. Okay, we continue. This is can be a metaphorical if it was supposed to not happen for real. You know what I mean? Like, let's say Muhammad, maybe he saw a dream. But this is not what Muhammad claimed. He claimed they come for real. And Muslim, they say that they left the stitches in his chest. And then, and dish of full of belief and wisdom was brought. And then Jibreel stuffed his chest and throat, blood vessels. Here we need to stop. He did not stuff the faith and the wisdom everywhere. You see, I learned, like when I read, I have to be careful, you know, especially like history books or religious books, you know, blah, 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 you know. I'm not good reading mathematics. Like, as an example, for me as an Arab, like the Muslim, they say, especially Arab Christian, like the Christian, they say 1 + 1 + 1 equal to 1. Exactly like you said that. Brother Anthony, the reason we cannot teach the Christian mathematics in our school. Because how you can let a Christian teach you that 1 + 1 + 1 is equal to 1? And the Christians like, what the heck? How we can answer this now? We are in trouble. What kind of mathematics we have? 1 + 1 + 1 is equal to 1 since when? Like, come on. Hey, but Abdul, we don't have 1 + 1 + 1. Who said that? We have one God. If God cannot be in how he want to be, or how he is, who are you to tell him? How come the Muslim don't ask their God, how come you have a shin? Okay, is Allah shin plus his hand plus his face, are they connected together to make one body or not? If they are not, well, that's mean Allah is not one. And if the Quran is not a created and Allah is not a created, so now we have two divine. Are they connected or not? I mean, even this, but the Muslims, they have only a logic work for them. So now the angel, he got the, you know, like he finished almost most of the surgery. He cleaned the dirt of Muhammad, as we heard from Muslims in that, like the dumb Ishmael, he said, to purify the body of Muhammad. And now it's time to stuff. Look at the word stuff. You see, this is not my translation. Excuse me, Muslims. It says here, let me zoom in. I want to zoom in. Because most of you, you don't have a good vision, you know? Stuffed. Do you see how powerful this word is? Stuffed. He just like took the dish and he put it in the mouth of Muhammad or in his belly. He's stuffed. So he was like pushing so hard to be sure that there's no more space left. It's not accepted, brother. Look how much import Abdul, the one who said this is metaphor. What is the metaphorical with stuffed? Do you know like any metaphorical with stuffed? So this is now, brother, the, you know, the prophet, belly, stomach, whatever. And now the angel is stuffing faith and wisdom everywhere. Enter, there's no more space. Be honest, how many of you now getting hungry now? Unbelievable. Okay, they will start leaving the chat now, going to their kitchen. I made a mistake. The prophet was stuffed, but not with normal food. Wisdom, brother, and faith. I don't know. I mean, you see, I think if Muhammad, he went to Indonesia, and the angel Jibril, he would change the material he stuffed him with. He would stuff him with rice. I mean, they have a nice food there, Indonesia, Thailand, you know, unbelievable. So, hey, Muslims, why he stuffed his chest and his throat, blood vessel with it? What is significant about this, brother? Who is going to explain to us? Anyone? If there's any Muslim would like to call me and tell me why this is happening. And don't be upset from me. I'm just reading what your prophet said. The one who's speaking there is your prophet. Because remember, there was nobody there. Only the two angels and Muhammad. That's it. The two angels go home after they finish their surgery. They are tired, my friend. They spend the whole night doing the surgery. It's not easy. I mean, a doctor, it takes him 24 hours to replace a heart. Like this day, they can even take the heart and put you in a machine, supposedly. But take long, long time. Jibril took him a lot of time because he took everything. He had to put the liver back, the stomach back, the, you know, everything, you know, like screws, everything. But I like to get answer for things, because here there's details. Obviously, those details are not meant to be for no reason. Remember, my friend, Prophet Muhammad didn't say things out of foolishness. He's a genius. So based on this, who is the genius Muslim can tell us why he said that the angel, he stuffed the dish which was full of belief and wisdom. And this is the only religion have dishes of wisdom and belief. And look, there's connected. There's a connection here, brother. Belief, wisdom. Because if you have a belief without wisdom, you are a full believer. Allah will not accept that. A full believer is somebody, he a fool, but believe in things. As an example, you know, only smart believers believe if they kiss a black stone, it's to erase their sin, brother. That's a smart belief. Only smart believers believe if they live in Australia, they can pray in the direction of Mecca. This is a smart belief, brother, because the earth is flat. It's a smart belief to drink camel urine. It's very healthy. The United Nations talk about it, brother. Barack Obama talk about it, brother. Open heart surgery take now 3 hours. You see, 3 hours in the time of Allah is like 1,000 years. The Quran says one day for Allah is 1,000 years for us. Are you with me? One day for Allah, brother, is equal to 1,000 years. So if the 1,000 year is equal to 24 hours of Allah, and then you say that he is taken 3 hours just for the heart, okay, that is 416,000 hours, brother. X three, 1,025 hours. Don't take me there, please. This is too much. So here we notice together that there is a special technique of Allah. Allah not only he installed faith and wisdom, he installed it in a specific location. Where? He stuffed it in his throat. Through his blood vessels. And now the prophet, he have a circulation of wisdom going all the way down to his feet, his penis, his stomach, all over, even his hair. If you cut the prophet's hair, you are cutting wisdom. If the prophet, he bleed wisdom and faith. What a bleeding, or let us say, what an extreme priceless blood that blood is. Faith and wisdom sent from Allah. But look, this story lead me to understand now, and you Muslims have to agree with me, that Allah, he cleansed Muhammad because obviously he's dirty. This is number one. Number two, let us make a list, hold on. So number one, Allah, he have to clean Muhammad. Cleaning. The Prophet. Which imply that Muhammad was dirty. And the Muslims agree that he was purifying him, right? So he must be dirty. Okay. He is dirty. So Allah is trying to clean the dirty Muhammad. Ah, mission is accomplished. Now Muhammad, he become clean. That's wonderful. Number two. Installing a dish of intelligence. You know, you cannot do such a thing with someone like Muhammad, because Muhammad is the most smart person ever. We have to understand that. However, Allah, He decide that the intelligence of His Prophet is bad. So He decided to install intelligence, a lot of intelligence, because Allah, He discovered that His Prophet is extremely a fool. So number two, intelligence installed. What kind of installation this? Who taught you to write the word installed like this? Unbelievable, very embarrassing. Okay. Intelligence, not installed, hold on. Intelligence, stuffed. Brother. To fix his stupidity. So obviously he was stupid. And he needed a surgery of his intelligence. So this is number two. Number three, faith. Faith is very important. And Allah, He need to install special dish of faith in Muhammad because he have none. Therefore, Allah, He decided to install faith in Muhammad, for he was obviously a kafir. And kafir mean evil, you know? He don't believe in Allah. He don't have faith. So we learn three things from such a beautiful story reported by the beautiful Prophet of Allah. That he needed special cleaning, for he was so dirty. He need special dish of intelligence, for he was so full. And he needed dish of faith, for he was so infidel. Take a selfie for this, because we will go back to the hadith. If we go back here, after the angel, he stuffed his throat, blood vessels with it, which means faith and wisdom. Then he closed it. He closed what? The chest. The end of the surgery. And now it is time to go to heaven. So what was the purpose of this surgery? Allah, He cannot take Muhammad to heaven in the way he is. Take a note, number one. Allah, He cannot take Muhammad to heaven in the way he is. What the way he is? Well, if we look at what he installed, we will find the way he is. What Allah, He installed? He installed wisdom. Abdullah Fattah, he is saying the following. Thank you, Abdullah, for enlighten us with amazing answer, brother. What's wrong with washing Prophet with Zamzam water, he was he didn't wash because he was dirty, but because he's blessed by Allah. Hey, my friend, so are you saying to me that Muhammad was not blessed until that time? And the water of Zamzam, which is a water in the ground, everybody can drink from it, is the one who will bless him? By what? By washing his chest? Who? Where you got this from? This is blessing or to wash? The hadith says he washed it. And actually, even you said. You said he did not wash because, which means you agree he washed. He was washed, not he was washing. But I will make you see better understanding. If we ask you, my friend, Abdul Fattah, was your prophet a clean person? Was your prophet a clean person? Yeah, S-A-W-T. What does that mean? Salawatullahi alayhi, what is that? You pray on Allah or you pray on Muhammad? What is this? Was Muhammad a clean person or he was a dirty person? Any Muslim can help us? Whatever you Muslims, you say, I will put it in the screen. Was Muhammad a clean person or a dirty person? Accept my call? Why you want to accept your call? Who are you? And my Skype is not open. Neither my PalTalk. Any Muslim can tell us if Muhammad is a clean person or not. Was he clean according to your understanding? You will give me $2,000? Ah, okay. Now I'm going to accept your call because you will give me $2,000, brother. Alhamdulillah. Somebody told you I'm like Muhammad. I take a private consultation money, like your prophet. In the Quran, he says, if you want to see the prophet in private consultation, you have to pay him. Keep your money to yourself. Go and donate to Somalia. Your nations are crossing the sea to Europe like crazy. From Afghanistan, from everywhere. Everybody is running out of Islam. Nobody will live in Islamic countries. He take a bath and he is clean. He take a bath and he was clean. Muslims, do you agree that Muhammad, he take a bath and he was clean? Our friend here, he says he was not washed by Zamzam because he was dirty. But let's go and see the hadith to examine if this is true or not. In a second, we will find out. How Muhammad, he take a bath? According to Muhammad and according to Muslims, Muhammad, he take a bath with dead dogs and women of blood from period and garbage. Any Muslim? So, if we read the description of this water there, it was not even to the height of your private part. And it is like 6 arm wide. So imagine you have a jacuzzi, or little, like let's say, little tiny swimming pool. You have dead dogs, not one dog. Not one dog. Dead dogs. Do you see it says dead dogs? It's not dogs swimming in the water, it is dead dogs. Who is saying that? The Muslims. And what is beside the dead dogs next to Muhammad's shoulder? stinking things. In Arabic, wannatan, which means the garbage, stinky garbage. A lot of garbage in the water. And what beside the stinking things and the dead dogs? Women menstruation rags. Well, I see many Muslims would like to call. Let us see. We will open Skype. Give me a second. But if you are going to talk like a kid, I'm going to block you, by the way. If you want to have a nice conversation, you are welcome. All right, we are logging into Skype. Okay. What is your name, my friend? The one, this is... Okay, call me, I'm a Muslim. Let us see this guy. He is not answering. Huzeifa Khan. Okay. I hope it's not ultimate fart. Hello?
Hello?
Yes, my friend, you are live on air. What do you like to say to us about the topic? Hello?
Hello, is my voice coming clear?
Yes, your voice is coming very clear, my friend. So what do you like to say to us about the topic? You heard what I was saying, right? About your prophet having a surgery, etc.
First of all, I would like to say, what's your problem with Islam? Why do you keep on saying negative things about Islam? You are a pessimistic person, you know?
You see, my problem is, I don't have a problem. I just don't want to love. What's your problem? I'm free. I can laugh at anything. I find it stupid, and I find Islam very stupid. Do you have a problem with that?
Yeah. How you find Islam stupid?
Well, here we go. Your prophet, he says that his God, he sent him a dish of faith and dish of wisdom, is stored in the chest. Don't you find this is stupid?
Yeah. So what? Did you say yes?
Did you say yes? So you yourself, you are laughing now. You just agreed that your prophet is stupid. So what kind
no,
of...
No, I didn't say that. I didn't say yes. Oh, I never said yes.
Okay, so what do you think what do you think about storing the dish of faith and wisdom?
I'm just asking you what's wrong in it. What's wrong in it? It's not...
I find it funny. Prove to me it's not funny. I say this is stupid, because since when faith and wisdom, they come in dishes?
Yes, for that you have to believe that in the unseen, you know?
What unseen? This is a dish.
If you believe in unseen, then you...
Fred, what unseen? This is a dish. It's a dish full of food. And this food is not normal food. It's a faith.
Who brought the dish?
Jibreel.
Who brought the dish?
Okay, Jibreel. So since when... Okay, explain to me why Allah, he needed to send a dish of wisdom to Muhammad to install it in his chest. Go ahead, I'm listening.
Yeah, because without wisdom, you can't understand Islam. Like, you are not able to understand Islam. And
okay.
Many of you Christians are not able to understand Islam. Okay. So wisdom is required for that.
Wonderful. So guys, so you are saying that your prophet, he could not understand Islam all those years until the angels, they installed this dish in his chest. So your prophet was a stupid fool all his life until they did the surgery, correct?
No, actually, the thing is, it is required for a Muslim or for a man to have wisdom from Allah. Allah gives the wisdom for Islam.
Okay.
How Allah gave you wisdom?
You are a Muslim. How Allah gave you wisdom?
Okay, Allah gave me wisdom through the knowledge. Okay, for Prophet Muhammad,
He did not give wisdom to Muhammad in the same way. He is not sending him knowledge. He is sending him a dish.
Because there was not knowledge present formerly.
Why Allah was not talking to Muhammad? Allah is not sending Jibreel with the Quran. Isn't it the Quran is a book of knowledge? So are you saying to me, oh, the Quran Muhammad received, oh, the Quran Muhammad received, did not help Muhammad, Muhammad is still a fool. So Allah, he gave up and he said, okay, I cannot do it no more. I cannot continue with this guy like this. So I'm going to send Jibreel. He will open his chest. He will force wisdom inside his chest. He will install it. He will zip it. So Muhammad cannot fart it.
Yeah, because
did you say here we go. Thank
prophets,
you.
So
why Allah? Allah did not send you a dish of wisdom yourself? He sent it to Muhammad.
Because Muhammad listen to my whole sentence.
Go ahead.
I'm saying that there is difference between prophet and the ordinary man. You know, because prophet. On Prophet, the revelations are revealed, you know.
Okay.
On us, the revelations are not revealed. We have to take knowledge through Islam. So, you know, to us, Allah give knowledge, Allah give wisdom through, you know, our good side. You know, there is a good side and bad side in every person. So, our good side, we get the wisdom. But in the case of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it was... Allah had to make sure that he knows that he is the prophet. So, you know, so Allah has to make sure that he knows that he has been chosen as a prophet.
Okay, but this has happened long after that. Muhammad already, he received Quran. Muhammad already, he spoke to the angel. Muhammad already been squeezed by the angel. So now Muhammad, he will know he's a prophet by a surgery in his chest. Let me ask you, did Allah did the surgery to Moses?
First thing is that surgery is done by human, not angels. Okay, so no, it is not a surgery.
It's done by angels. So it's a surgery.
No, it's done by humans. You know,
okay,
by
angels, hold on. It says here, read me carefully, read with me. It says, then Jibreel cut open from here to there, from his throat to his testicles. So what do you mean this is a human doing the surgery?
Okay, I can't see your YouTube because I am in the call with you.
Okay,
so how can I
send you? I will send you the link to your Skype, my friend, and you can open it and you can read it. Here we go. This is your Skype. I'm going to send it to you. All right. And this is the link. And this is an authentic hadith from Sahih Bukhari. So Jibreel cut open from here to there, from his throat to his testicles to his balls. May Allah bless his balls.
So, if he does, so what you find negative in that? You know, what you find negative in that?
Okay, you are contradicting yourself. I'm not talking about negative or positive. I'm talking about a stupid story. It does not make sense because wisdom does not come by a surgery.
No.
Let me ask you, if Allah want to fix something, if Allah need to fix something, do he need to make a surgery or he can say, fixed is going to be fixed?
Yeah, Allah can fix it in every way, you know, but...
Okay, give me the easiest way to fix the problem of Muhammad now. Can Allah make Muhammad wise by saying, be wise? Can he do that?
Can't you see the vision that Allah wants Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to see himself what's happening with him so that he can believe in the unseen? You know, nobody has seen the unseen except the Prophet.
Nobody's seen the unseen. How it is unseen and he's seen the unseen? If he's seen the unseen, that means it's not unseen. You just said nobody's seen the unseen.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hold on.
You said to me the Prophet, he's seen the unseen. What is the unseen? What do you mean by the unseen?
By unseen, I mean the angels. Can you see angel?
Okay, but isn't your prophet, he sent the angels, the Quran says, Allah, he sent the angel Jibreel to Mary?
Yeah, they were prophets.
Okay, Mary is a prophet? Mary is a prophet?
To Mary, the angel came in the form of human, you know,
did the angel came to your prophet in the form of a human or a form of an angel?
Both.
You said seeing the angel is seeing the unseen. Well, the donkey can see the angels according to your prophet.
Yeah, we can see angels, but we see the angels,
focus with me. You're a prophet. When he saw first time an angel, he could not recognize him. He asked his wife, Khadija. Okay. How Muhammad, do you remember the story about Khadija asking Muhammad to sit in her lap?
Yes.
Okay. So
to trust in Allah. Yes.
Okay. So Muhammad, he saw somebody in the corner. He do not know who is he. And then he said to Khadija, "I see someone in the corner." She said to him, "When he come to you next time, let me know." So he saw him again. He said, she said to him, "Okay, sit in the top of my left leg." He said. She said, "Do you see him?" He said, "Yes." She said, "Sit in the top of my right leg." "Do you see him?" Still, "Yes." Then she asked him to sit in the top of her, and she took off her clothes. She said, "Do you see him?" He said, "No." She said, "Praise be Allah, he's an angel." So how Khadija, she was able to recognize the angel, and Muhammad, the one who see him, do not know there's an angel?
Because Prophet Muhammad was in fear. You know, if you see a ghost light right now, if see a jinn right,
so
you will be in fear.
Okay,
you will
Muhammad,
not be
okay, Muhammad had a fear, no problem. Okay, I will go with you. How a donkey, when he see an angel, you know, so how a rooster he can recognize the angel and Muhammad he cannot. The hadith in front of you, it says, when you hear the cock crow, ask Allah for his favor upon you, for surely he have seen an angel. When you hear the bray of the donkey, seek refuge in Allah from shaitan, for surely he saw the devil. So according to Muhammad, a rooster is more qualified than him. He needed the legs of his wife to do striptease for him to discover if this is an angel or not. A rooster, he do not need his chicken wife. He find right away this is an angel. Now, Muhammad, he needed the installation of the wisdom. Is that so because he can recognize the angels because he was so fool?
Yeah, so because so that he could take the knowledge, because the knowledge of Islam is not for everyone.
What is the knowledge?
Many people go astray from it.
The knowledge of Islam given to Muhammad. Okay, the knowledge of Islam given to Muhammad is the Quran, correct?
Yes, yes.
Okay, did Allah install Quran in his chest or he installed something else?
Yeah, you know, Quran was you know better than me. You have studied more Islam than me. You
I'm asking you, my friend. Did Allah install Quran in his chest, or Allah he gave him Quran by the angel, you know, by recitation? If the Quran is the word of Allah, it is the wisdom given to Muhammad, then there is no need for a surgery. So what the surgery for?
You see, without that, he could not be able to understand what Islam means. You know, every person
guys,
is not.
Guys, did you hear what he, our friend? Okay, thank you. Guys, did you hear what he said? He said, without the surgery, Prophet Muhammad could not understand the Quran.
Yeah, because it has the knowledge of previous scriptures.
So we can say that Allah he installed tafsir in the chest of Muhammad.
Yeah, by wisdom, you know, wisdom by wisdom comes the knowledge. If you have wisdom,
So Allah now he installed tafsir in the chest of Muhammad, but still Muhammad cannot explain the Quran. Isn't it Muhammad? He said that the Quran, there is a big part of it. Nobody knows what they mean, save Allah. So what the point?
Yes.
Okay, can you explain to me? I will go with you. So now Muhammad, he can understand the Quran after the surgery, correct?
Yeah.
Where the sun set?
Where does the sun set?
Uh-huh.
Sunset in west.
Where?
Sunset in west.
That's not true. I mean, this is how it appear, but the sun did not set really. According to your prophet, the sun set in hot water. So now your prophet, said Allah he installed wisdom in his chest, and now he have understanding of the Quran. So in the Quran it says that Zulqarnain he found the sun setting in murky water, and now Muhammad he understood the Quran, correct?
Yeah, it is a metaphor, you know.
Metaphor for what? What a metaphor? Hold on. How it's a metaphor? He said to the guy, "Do you know where the sun goes?" He said, "Allah and his apostle know best." He said, "It goes in a muddy hot water." Explain to us the metaphor of muddy hot water.
See, listen to me. the knowledge of Islam is so much wise, so much vast, you know. So not all the things in Islam are meant for all the Muslims coming for the future. You know, some things are
for the Muslims who accompany. Hold on. You told me that Allah, He installed tafsir, knowledge, in the chest of Muhammad, so he can understand the Quran, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Quran chapter 18, verse number 86, it says there is a guy, his name, the guy with the two horn. He went all the way until he found the sitting place of the sun, which is very stupid because the sun set everywhere. There's no sitting place of the sun. And he found it sitting in a spring of a black, muddy, hot water. You're a prophet now. He's going to explain to us the verse. Do you agree with me that your prophet, he understands the Quran better than anyone? Or you don't?
Yes, he understood the Quran, yes.
Okay. Well, you're a prophet, he explained, and he said, well, muddy water is where the sun set. It's hot water, read it. This is the hadith. So now this is Muhammad after the surgery, saying stupid things. How do you explain that?
Okay, send me the hadith. Kindly send me the hadith.
Here we go. It's in the front of you. This is the hadith. I will send it to you in Skype. Open it and read it for us. Go ahead.
Okay, let me read. Allah's Messenger prayed Maghrib when the sun had set. Oh, no, no, this is not. It's okay.
The second one. I've got it. The second one.
4002. I'm opening it.
Okay.
I was sitting behind the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was riding a donkey while the sun was setting. He asked, do you know where the sun sets? I replied, Allah and His Apostle knows best. He said, it sets in a spring of warm water. Yeah. It doesn't say literally, you know, it is used as a metaphor.
Where it says metaphor? Where it says that? Where you get this from? The guy, he was sitting in the back of Muhammad, and it saw the sun setting, the sun is going down. Muhammad says, do you know where the sun goes?
Yes.
Okay.
You know, actually,
do you know where it says? Does it say in the front of you, do you know where this set? Does it say that?
Yes.
Okay.
They were saying
something physical or something metaphorical.
Yeah, the location. The location was being discussed here. Do you know where this sun sets?
The location is metaphorical. Okay, what is the metaphorical of hot water? Go ahead. The sun sets in hot water. What is the metaphorical of it?
It sets in a spring of warm water, you know. Okay. The spring of warm water, it sets on that, you know, the visual scene that you see will be like it is setting in a spring of warm water.
Who in the world he see that sun setting in a spring of water is little water? The sun sitting in
if you google it, you will see there are many people who go and they have they show the pictures of sun being setting.
Really? The sun setting in a spring of water?
You know this earth has more water than the land. So sun sets in where it is water, sun sets there.
So no, hold on. There's pictures, people showing you the sun setting in a spring of water?
Yeah, no, not in the spring of water.
Mm-hmm.
It's metaphorical, you know.
Okay, metaphorical of what? You keep saying metaphor. Your prophet, he said, hold on. You are making things up. It says there, it's set in a spring of warm water. Did he say there it's a metaphorical? My friend, you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay.
What happened?
Where you got this word metaphorical from?
You see, in Quran, it also says metaphorically
Let us see the metaphorically. Hold on. Can you read the Quran with me? It says here, until when he reached the setting place of the sun. Is the setting place of the sun metaphorical or it's a place? The guy, he keep walking.
He went all the way
to the end of the earth.
Until, let me search. Me, you can send me
chapter 18, verse number 84, etc. Let me send you the link. Here we go.
Chapter 18, Surah Al Kahf,
yeah, 84, 85, 86. You can even read it from before if you want.
Okay, verse number 84.
Yeah,
I will do it.
84, 80, 85, 86. So it says until this guy he took away, we established for him in earth. This is a real person who was going to war. He went, he kept traveling until he reached the setting place of the sun. Does it say that in verse number 86?
Yeah, until he reached the setting point of the sun, which appeared to him to be setting in a spring of murky water.
Where in the Quran it says, where in the Quran it says which appeared to him?
Yeah, in Quran.com, this is the website.
My friend, this is a false translation. Here we go. You can copy. This is the Arabic. It says, حتى إذا بلغ مغرب الشمس وجدها تغرب في عين حمئة.
Okay.
There's no way it says it appeared to him. That's a lie. There's no way. You see, the Muslim are corrupting the Quran. Does it say in anywhere in the Quran it appeared to him?
So let me
be honest with me. No. Does it say in the verse anywhere it appeared to him, or this is additional? The Muslims are lying.
Okay, so let me read another translation. Until when he reached the setting of a point, he found it as if it also means the same.
Okay, hold on. How the previous translation says it appeared to him, and now there's no it appeared to him. What happened?
Yeah, he found it. That means the same. He found it.
No, he found it. It's mean he found, my friend. No.
It's like empty voice and passive voice.
Hold on. Who is the one saying he found it?
He found it. Of course, it is the revelation of Allah. So okay, Allah is telling the story of
that. So Allah is saying he found it. So Allah reporting false find or reported what he found? Allah is lying? If I say to you, this guy, he went home and he found his wife watching a movie. Am I reporting to you a true find or it's a false lie? Which will not...
Actually, it was not setting in the spring of water, but it appears to Zulkarnain like
where,
it was setting
in the spring. Where it says the word appear? Can you show me where it says it appeared to him?
Yeah, that is the same in the translation.
Where?
He found it.
No, this is a lie. Which appeared... It says, okay, does it say, read with me carefully, my friend. It says, he reached the setting place of the sun. Where is that, setting place of the sun?
Until he reached the setting point of the sun, yes, it is written.
Okay, where that location? This guy, he keep going. Your God
we
is
don't know
about, is talking about him, the earth, the whole earth established for him. Read it, verse number 84. So now this guy, he went around the earth. So this is not a one-day journey. And now he keep going, until, this is the point of a stop, when he reached the setting place of the sun. Where we can find the setting place of the sun?
You can't understand that. It means that when he was traveling, the sun was not setting, but at a certain place.
So this guy
the sun,
who was going for years traveling, the sun was not setting.
Not years. Not I didn't say but years.
Does it say he established for him? The guy he established. Allah established for him to control the earth. This guy he conquered.
You aren't even understanding what I am saying.
No, you are not. I'm not understanding. You are just making things up. It says, "Verily, we establish him in the earth." And we gave him the means of everything. Then he followed away.
I'm not making things up.
Okay, listen.
Until
he reached the setting place of the sun. The setting place of the sun, I can reach it without moving one step from my place right now. Do you agree?
Yeah.
Okay.
You can, so but if you are traveling,
it doesn't say he keep going until the sun set. It says until he reached the sitting place of the sun.
Yeah.
Okay. So he reached what? He did not reach the time. He reached the sitting place. Does it say the sitting place?
So now will you allow me to tell you what is this?
Okay. What's going on?
Okay.
Yeah. Supposedly Allah installed additional wisdom in your chest and now you know the answer. Okay. Yeah. Go ahead.
Okay. I want you to consider that you are traveling in an airplane.
Okay.
You first let us suppose you are in America and then you go to a far country.
Mm-hmm.
So now when you are moving from America, the sun is not setting.
Mm-hmm.
But when you go to a place, a certain place like the other country, you found that sun was setting there.
Uh-huh.
So this is the point of setting of sun.
But my friend, you jumped something. You jumped something very important. He keep going. He reach a place of the sun setting. He reach it. And then he stopped there. forget about now about the sun setting. He reached the place where the sun set. Where is that?
It does not say he reached the place where the sun set.
It says
he reached the place where the sun was setting.
No, it says.
The setting point.
It doesn't say that. It says. It's your Muslim translator in front of me. It says, until he reached the setting place of the sun.
So what according to you, a setting place, as you are saying me, the setting place means that...
Let us go with your funny explanation. If you go with me little verses more, it says here, he changed another direction, verse number 89. And then he says, he keep going, until he came to the rising place of the sun.
Yeah, 1 minute, I'm reading.
Okay. Where is the rising place of the sun? So this guy, he keep going, until he found the rising place of the sun.
Then he traveled a different course until he reached the rising point of the sun. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Where is the rising point of the sun?
It means the same as the previous one.
Hold on. The guy, let us say it was two days journey. Okay, now he arrived to the sunset place, right? The previous verse. Now he changed direction. So he kept going during the night until he reached the sun rising place. It says he found it rising on people whom Allah had provided no shelter. So that point is where those people live, correct?
Yes.
Okay. And he found it rising in those people, not in other people, only those people, correct?
Yes.
Okay, so now he come to the rising place, and that place, there's people who live there, correct?
Yes.
Okay, but the rising place of the sun is everywhere, correct?
No, listen to me.
What country you live in? What country you live in?
I live in Pakistan.
In Pakistan, okay. Do I need to go to Pakistan to see the sunrise, or I can see it in America?
Yeah, you don't need to come here, but if you travel from your country to here, which is far away, you could find that sun is rising from a point.
There's no sun rising in a point, because first of all, he is talking about rising place.
East is the point, there's no east,
there's no west. This is all, like, you know, this is something we created, because there's no east, there's no west. What east, what west? I can change direction now. If you make me a king of all the whole earth, I can change the map. I can name the southeast, I can name the east south. It's a word. Now listen to me carefully. When he came to rising place of the sun, he found the sun rising on people. So this is a specific location, and specific people are there, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Now, the rising place of the sun, if it is not about a specific place, this verse is stupid, because there's the sunrise everywhere.
Yes, sunrise everywhere. To understand the verse, we have to go
and see what Muhammad said about this. Your prophet, he explained, he said the sun set in a murky water. Yes. You tried to get away with it. You said it's a metaphorical. Do you have any proof that this is metaphorical?
Yes, I can prove.
Okay, go ahead. Show me.
I already told you that earth is more water and less land.
This is another question. Listen. Don't play like I'm not a kid. Maybe you are a kid. I'm being patient with you.
Yeah.
Where it says that this is metaphorical, the hadith in front of me, the man was sitting behind your prophet. Muhammad, he said to him, do you know where the sun is setting? The guy, he said, Allah and his apostle know best. Did he say to him, I'm going to give you a parable? Did he say to him, I'm going to give you a metaphorical? He said, it's set in a spring of warm boiling water. So how in the world you try to escape the stupidity of the Quran and the stupidity of the hadith, and now you try to make it metaphorical.
So, okay, I want you to confirm that what I say.
Did your prophet reach the point? Did your prophet reach? Hold on. Did your prophet reach the point where the sun set? No.
Okay, you tell me. Is your country?
Don't tell me my country. Your country. I'm asking you. When your prophet said the sun goes and set in murky water, he was talking about the movement of the sun, or it's a metaphorical?
Because in my country, sun rises from the...
Forget about your sun, your country.
Same point.
In his country, the sun rises every day. This is not the question. I'm saying to you, when you're a prophet... Okay, hold on. Let me ask you. According to your religion, do the sun move or no?
Yes, sun move.
From where to where? From the east to the west?
No, sun moves. Actually, sun rotates around the center of the galaxy in which we live. Okay. It is Milky Way.
But the day, the 24 hours hour a day, is that because the sun moving from the east to the west, or this is wrong?
No, actually, you know, I can answer you there. Just listen to me, okay? So don't interrupt me. I will answer you there, okay?
Okay.
So see, the sunrise from east and sun goes and sets in the west. It means that, you know, Earth is rotating around the sun. Earth is revolving and rotating.
Can you give me my friend, I'm not smart like you. You are a genius. I'm asking you, do the sun every day go from the east to the west? Either you say yes or you say no.
Yes, it goes.
The sun goes every day from the east to the west? The sun is moving every day?
Passively, we can say that it goes.
No, does it because, go, you know, or this is how we see it?
This is how we see it, yeah, okay. Passively.
So, it doesn't go, it's the Earth going around itself, correct?
Yes, okay. No, Earth's not going around the sun, Earth's rotating in its own axis.
I'm talking about now the 24 hours a day. Stop playing like a kid. I'm talking to you as an adult, please. The 24 hours a day. Okay. The sun now is going to set. Is the sun really setting, or the Earth is going around itself? Is the sun is moving around the Earth, or the Earth is moving around itself to have the 24 hours a day?
Earth is moving around the sun.
No, the sun is not moving around the sun to make the 24 hours a day. The sun is moving, the Earth is moving around itself.
Yeah, Earth is moving around itself and revolving around the sun.
Yeah, but this is so that will make different stories. I'm talking about the 24 hours a day, the day and the night. So when the day and the night happen, is that because the Earth is moving around itself, or because the sun moving around the Earth?
Yeah, it's because Earth rotates around its own axis.
So anyone who say that the sun set and the sun rise, it's happening because the sun going around the Earth is a fool. Do we agree?
Okay, how it relates to Islam, please tell me.
Don't change the topic. I'm asking you now. If somebody says that the sun, the day we have, the day and the night, 24 hours, happen because the sun is moving around the Earth, is he a fool or he's smart?
No, he's not, because
He's not what?
He has saved wisdom, so he's not. So can you tell me how is
Hold
it
on,
related
man.
To Islam?
What are you talking about? I'm saying if somebody, a person, his name is somebody, okay? He said the sun move every morning, the sun rise, and then the sun go to the west. You said...
You know, he's not...
Don't interrupt me. I'm not talking about Muhammad now. Stop being a foolish.
Okay.
I'm saying a man. Let us say a guy, he said to you, you saw him in the coffee shop. He said to you, the reason we have day and night because the sun move around the earth. Is that person an ignorant, or he is a smart person?
If he says sun goes around the earth, he is ignorant.
Thank you very much. So is your prophet. Here we go. This is your prophet hadith. Okay. This is your prophet hadith.
Show me.
Explaining how the sun goes around the earth. Here we go. I will give you the link so you can open it from your side. And thank you for getting your prophet busted. So it took us all this time trying to play games with me. But thank God, your prophet, he never keep his mouth shut, and he talk too much. And the more you talk, you make poo-poo. Go ahead, read it. Okay, read it. Everybody will laugh at you now. Everybody heard you saying the one who say that the sun go around the earth to make the day and the night is ignorant.
let me just read the hadith. The professor asked me at sunset, do you know where the sun goes? I replied, Allah is till it prostrates itself
read it slow. We want everybody to read it with your voice, please. Read carefully. The prophet asked me, continue.
The prophet asked me at sunset, do you know where the sun goes? Okay. I replied, Allah and his apostle know better. He said, it goes till it prostrates itself underneath the throne and takes the permission to rise again, and it is permitted, and then a time will come when it will be not allowed. It will be about to prostrate itself, but its prostration will not be accepted, and it will be and it will ask permission to go on its course, but it will not be permitted. But it will be ordered to return whence it has to come. It has come, and so it will rise in the west. And that is the interpretation of the statement of Allah. And when sun and the sun runs in its fixed course for a term decreed, and that is the decree of Allah, the Exalted in Might and the All-Knowing.
Thank you. So now your Prophet explained the Quran. Not only is saying Hadith, he's saying the sun runs.
Can I explain
course.
It now? Can I explain it now?
You can. What do you mean explain it? The Prophet explained already. He said, "Do you know where the sun goes?" He said, "No. Allah and His Apostle knows best." Even this one need explanation, guys.
You are saying it's incorrect.
Hold on. So, was your prophet explaining the Quran?
You're saying it's incorrect. Can I show you?
Was your prophet explaining the Quran? Listen, he said, where the sun goes at the time of the sunset. Did he say where the sun goes?
Can I prove you wrong?
Does it say where the sun goes?
Yes.
Okay, so your prophet asking where the sun goes, correct?
Yes.
Okay, so the sun is going, and then he says, and this is between two brackets, at the time of the sunset. The guy replied that Allah and Muhammad know better. Wonderful. Muhammad continues saying, it goes, i.e. Yeah. travel. Does it say i.e. travel?
Yeah.
Okay. You are the one who said, if somebody said the sun travel around the earth, he is ignorant.
Yeah.
Okay. So your prophet is ignorant. He's a false prophet.
So can I prove you wrong now?
Okay, well, go ahead. What prove me wrong? What can you
I
said?
You
agreed with me.
Can I prove you?
Go ahead. Prove me wrong. What? Wrong.
No, I will prove it wrong.
Okay, go ahead.
I'm going to prove you ignorant. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. No. So now everyone will see you are ignorant, not our prophet. So. This hadith, you know, where's my Google? Sorry. So in this hadith, Prophet asked the companion that, do you know where the sun goes? So you know, I told you already formerly that some hadith. This is the life of Prophet. You know, this is the life of Prophet. It is not Quran. Quran is meant for everyone. Hadith is not meant for everyone. Hadith, from hadith, we take what is the life of Prophet, how he explained everything. So, you know, so he is telling his companion. So, you know, at that time, science was not so much, advanced. So Allah Almighty, you know, Prophet does not say any word without the permission of Allah and without what Allah says. So, he told him the companion that the sun goes, moves, travels, and until it goes under the throne of Allah and asks the permission to rise. So you know, you have you must have heard the hadith about that Allah comes to the nearest heaven in the early morning. So it is the same time of after the sun is gone, sun rises from somewhere else, and that is the same time in which Allah comes to the nearest heaven, and the throne is the nearest heaven. So when the sun is about to rise in another country, when it is about to rise in another country, it asks permission from Allah to spread its light in that country. So you know, it means this. So it proves you are ignorant. You don't know the meaning of hadith.
Okay.
So our prophet is not ignorant.
Okay. Let us see this. Who is this stupid here? Does it say here that it's going to ask permission to go back, and then it's going to be ordered to rise from the west?
Yeah. Go back.
Okay. How the sun is going to rise from the west? It's going to be order to return whence it has come from. Does it say in that? So now the son came to Allah, and Allah is saying to the son, you cannot rise from the east no more. Go where you came from, where she came from the west.
Europe,
okay, and then the Quran says, and your prophet quoting Quran says, and this is what it's meant, that the sun runs into a fixed course every day. So the sun runs into a course every day. Okay, now let me ask you. You said that Allah, he come down every third part of the night. Why he come down?
Yeah.
Why he come down?
Because he comes near to the, Allah is most loving. He comes near to the creation to bless. Okay,
you said
blessings come when Allah comes.
Okay,
you don't even understand.
You said he come in the lowest heaven, correct?
Yes, yes.
Okay. How many heaven there is in Islam?
There are seven heavens.
All right. So I want you to think with me. Now, you just said that Allah, he come down every day in the third part of the night. Do we agree?
Yeah.
All right.
Yes.
So this is heaven. I'm going to draw in the screen. This is heaven number seven. This is heaven number six. This is heaven number five. This is heaven number four. Three, two, one. So your God Allah, he go down every day to heaven number one. Do we agree on that?
Yes.
All right. So now Allah is inside heaven number one. Do we agree on that?
Yes.
So
yes.
Allah is inside his creation.
No, the first heaven is not this. This is earth.
Okay.
Hold on.
I just said, so Allah is inside his creation. And you said no. Is the heaven the creation of Allah?
Yeah.
Okay. So Allah coming down, and you agree, coming down, heaven
what
number
you
seven. Hold on. Everybody's laughing, man. People are dying laughing at you. Heaven number one.
No.
Heaven number two. Heaven number three. Heaven number four. Number seven. So this is heaven number seven. It is in the top. This is number seven. Allah, he is coming down. Coming down where? To heaven. Yes. To heaven number one. Correct.
Yes.
Okay. So Allah, he come down to heaven number one. This is heaven number one. And is heaven number one is the creation of Allah?
Yes.
Okay.
So is that throne. So is that throne creation of Allah.
Okay. So, heaven number seven, both of them, they are the creation of Allah. Do we agree?
Yes.
Okay. So Allah is inside his creation.
Yeah.
Okay.
Allah established himself for himself the throne.
Okay,
yes.
Guys, no, hold on. So Allah now is inside his creation. So Allah is a smaller
no,
than
okay. Not inside the creation. Allah
what
comes
you
to the
know,
nearest.
No, you just agreed. You said yes. Everybody heard you. I said, is Allah is now inside his creation? You said yes. Okay. So now Allah is a smaller. Is Allah bigger than his creation or smaller?
So ignorant. You think no one can do a mistake? You grip a mistake of a person and you keep on torturing him on that mistake.
Guys, he made a mistake. I will allow you to correct it. Okay. So now Allah coming down. Is it you who said Allah coming down?
Yes, Allah comes down.
Okay. So Allah come down from heaven number seven to heaven number one. Do we agree?
Yes.
All right. When Allah he arrived to heaven number one, is he still in heaven number seven or he is in heaven number one now?
He is Al-Azim is the name of Allah.
This
so
is not the question. This is not the question. Stop running away from the question. Embarrassment. Is Allah now? Okay. Allah, he came down to heaven number one. Is he still in heaven number seven or he is in heaven number one now?
Allah's throne is taken
this
by
is not the question.
Angels
this is not the,
in the heaven number one.
Did I ask you about the question?
Abdul,
listen. Allah now coming down. He took his throne with him. He did not take it. It's not a question. Allah himself is not a piece of a chair. I'm talking about Allah. Allah, he came down to the lowest heaven. And you are the one who quoted the hadith for me. Wonderful. So now yes. Allah is he still in heaven number seven, or now Allah is in heaven number one?
Okay, will you now let me ask you a question?
Don't ask me a question. Either you say he is in heaven. Has... Don't ask me a question. Answer the question. Is Allah now still in heaven number seven, or now he is in heaven number one?
I'm asking you a question because you are not letting me answer the question.
I don't want to. Because I want to explain to me what you just said. Don't ask me questions. Either you say... Is it you who says Allah come down?
Yes.
Okay. I said come and down. Come and down. Allah is moving, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Allah moves...
No.
What no?
You don't know how Allah moves. How Allah has established himself over the throne, and the angels carry the throne. Angels carry the throne downward. Angels carry the throne upward. How can you be like that?
This is not the question.
You know all of the things.
Okay. Do Allah come down when he come down? Is he moving down, or the word down does not make sense? Is he going down?
Yes, he.
Is he going
down? Yes, he comes down. And his throne, only his throne is big enough
to... guys, his throne is his bike. Okay, now Allah is on the top of his throne, and he is coming down with the chair. He cannot leave his chair. That will not change anything. So now Allah come down with his chair, and now he is in heaven number one. Do you agree?
You know, in heaven number one doesn't mean inside the heaven number one. Can be equal to the level.
Okay, guys, in heaven does not mean inside the heaven. I mean, have you ever heard of a joke like this? So when Allah, he come down from where? From the seven heaven, correct?
No, who said you he comes down from the seventh heaven?
Isn't he in the top of the seventh heaven? Isn't he in the top of the seventh heaven?
No, he is above the seventh heaven.
Above, okay, in the top. I just said in the top. Okay, guys, he's above. Okay, so now Allah, Mr. Above, he is coming down, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Coming down where? To heaven number one, correct?
On the level of heaven number one, yes.
Okay, guys, in the level of heaven number one. So now Allah, when he come in the third part of the night, he is where?
He is on the level of heaven number one and above that.
Thank you. So guys, he is...
Because we can't measure the size of
Allah.
Okay,
so he is in the heaven number one. So Allah, he passed through heaven number 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and he stopped in above the heaven number one, correct?
You can't know how much Allah loves you, you know?
Allah loves me. He will give me 70 years orgasm and a long penis. That is not love, my friend. This is a punishment. Imagine a guy, he have an endless penis, he's walking with it. That's not fun. So don't change the topic. Now Allah, he love you. Allah, now he's inside his creation. So how you Muslim you say how God can be inside his creation?
I just said you don't know Allah, how much Allah loves you, because
this is
you
the question.
Strive against
Allah.
You strive against
we agree, me and you, and you got yourself busted. Now we agree that Allah now is inside his heaven. So Allah is inside his heaven. That means he's inside his creation. Let me ask you. You said that Allah, he come down with his chair, correct?
See, the heaven does not cover all the space. Okay? So
heaven. Different question. You said Allah, he come down with a chair, correct?
Yes.
Okay. But isn't the Quran says that the chair of Allah is in the size of the earth and the heaven?
Yes.
Okay. So how he come down with it when it is bigger than all of them?
So didn't I tell you that
he
comes to the level, he don't come inside there.
How he come to the level, but you don't come like in the side, there's other side, there's other space.
Yeah, because heaven, you know, we don't know how much space is there in heaven. So, you know, we don't know how much space in space.
Okay, is it in the hadith he says Allah, he come down to the lowest heaven? Did it say in the side of it, or it says to the lowest heaven?
So I think if someone thinks about it, he can come to the conclusion that heaven cannot cover all the size that is present in this space. So he comes in the level of, you can also see that.
Okay, let us see the hadith, because people are dying laughing at you trying to fix it. So you're a prophet, obviously. He is a mentally ill person who does not know what he is talking about. He is making himself as a prophet, claiming knowledge, and he says stupid things, and now you try to fix it. Read with me carefully. This is the hadith in the front of us. It says, our Lord, the blessed, the exalted, descended every night. Descends. Does it say descend?
Yes, descends.
Okay. Does it say to the lowest heaven?
Yes.
Okay, so he descend from where?
From, we don't know the location.
Okay, from above the seven heaven, right? Okay, guys, so he is above. Let me draw the seven. Here we go. I will make a drawing, so to make it simple for people to understand. And I will use the word you say to me, to explain the point. So now Allah is above. I will draw a line. This is heaven number seven. All right. This is heaven number seven. And Allah is here in the top. Allah. We will type,
yes,
Allah.
Yes, above this.
Okay. This is Allah in the top of the heaven number seven. Wonderful. Now, Allah is in the heaven number seven, and he is going to come down. Correct?
Yes.
Okay. He will come down where?
He will come to the heaven number one.
Heaven number one. Thank you very much. So he will come to heaven number one. Remember what you said. You just said he will come to heaven number one. He will come to, not beside. Everybody heard you. So Allah will come to heaven number one. Fantastico. Here we go. We put one. So now Allah, he moved from heaven number seven or above seven. He moved to heaven number one. Allah is here now.
Yeah.
Okay, and you agree with me, thank you. So now Allah is located in a new location, and that is the lowest heaven. Oh boy. You hear me now? Do you hear me?
Yeah.
Do you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay.
So yes, now, yes, I hear
so
you.
Now
I hear
Allah,
you.
You agreed with me that Allah now in heaven number one. In heaven number one. Wonderful. So is Allah now,
because you,
is Allah is,
you can't measure the size of Allah.
What the size of Allah? He's inside the heaven number one. It says in the front of us, he go down, he descends every night. My friend, don't tell me now metaphorical and garbage. Shame on you. Stop playing games. So does it say here that he go to the lowest heaven, not near it, not in the side of it? It says he go down, he descend to the lowest heaven. So what is that? The direction is the lowest heaven, and you agree. Thank you. So now Allah is moving between two location. One is above the seven heaven, and one is above the first heaven. Do you agree in that?
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So Allah is moving between his creation.
Yeah, so what can you do about that?
We agree that Allah, he can be inside his creation. So why?
Yeah, because you,
so why
you
are
don't
Muslim, so how, you, so why you, are you Muslim? So why you Muslim? You say how Jesus have a body of a man, and then God, he go inside the body he created. Here we go. Your God Allah,
okay,
he go
okay,
inside.
Okay.
Your God Allah, he go inside his creation.
Yeah, I thought that those were the Christians who said that Jesus Christ come as a human being. So, you know.
Is Allah a human being?
Those. No.
What is your proof?
No.
What is your proof?
But Jesus Christ was.
What is your proof?
Jesus was.
Okay, what is your proof that Allah is
not
a human being?
Allah himself says that he is Lord. Who creates?
Jesus.
So he is the creator.
The Quran says that Jesus is. Jesus is a creator.
In another word,
Jesus is a creator. Secondly, Allah, he said he looked like Jesus.
No, Allah in second verse, Allah says that there is no example of Allah. Meaning that Allah does not look like anyone.
Okay, let's see if this is true.
So, Allah, if you see the fruits of God,
are you accusing your prophet that he is a foolish man? He do not know what he's talking about. You just said that Allah does not look like any man, correct?
Yes, yes.
Okay, but Allah, prophet, after he made a surgery to fix his stupidity, installing wisdom, and faith in his chest, he said that Allah, he looked like Jesus. And this is the hadith. Read it for me.
Okay. Here we go again.
Take your time to read it. Go ahead.
Okay. So you want me to read it slowly, or I can read it like I want? Okay, let me read it slowly. I have told you so much about the Dajjal that I am afraid you may not understand. The Antichrist is short, hand-toed, woolly-haired, one-eyed and eye-sightless, and neither protruding nor deep-seated. If you are confused about him, know that your Lord is not one-eyed. Where does it say that Allah looks like a person or...
Okay, Muhammad is worried that the Muslims will think that the false Messiah is Allah, correct?
No, he is worried that they will not understand how he looks like, how is he like.
Read carefully. He said, I am afraid that you may not understand. He's talking about what? About the Antichrist.
The Antichrist.
Okay. The Antichrist is what? Is short, hinted, woolly haired, one eyed, and an eye sightless, neither protruding or nor deep seated. If you are confused about him, confused with whom? Let us see. Confused about him, know that your Lord is not one eyed. So the Muslim will be confused.
Yes, because he will. Because he will claim him to be the God. Okay. So that's why he...
Wonderful. No, he will claim to be the God by saying he's the Messiah. Thank you very much. So now he is saying to them, if you are confused about him, know that your Lord is not one eye. So they will be confused about him because of the look, obviously. So Muhammad, he find only one way to prove that this is not Allah. He said, this guy is one eye sightless. So he did not say Allah is not a man. You see, because if Allah is not a man, the Muslim should not be confused anyway. If Allah is not a man, if Allah is not a cow, if Allah is not a donkey, I do not need to say to you, this donkey is one eye, your God is not. What is the comparison between them? If Allah is not a man anyway, then he should say, why you will be confused anyway? This guy is just a man, so Allah is not a man. And he did not say that. He says that this guy...
Yeah, because...
He said that this guy is short. He have a problem. Allah is short. Allah is neither deep seated, and if you are confused about him, know that your Lord is not one-eyed. So the only difference between the Dajjal, the false Messiah, and the true Allah is one eye.
Okay, now will you allow me to explain?
Go ahead.
Okay. Okay, you have allowed me to explain. Kindly don't interrupt. I will explain to you all. Okay. In this it says, I have told you so much about Dajjal that I am afraid you may not understand. You know, when you tell someone a lot about something, okay, they confuse some things with each other.
Okay,
so
can you stop a second? No, hold on, guys. So Muhammad, when he told too much, look what you just said. When Muhammad, he tell you too much about something that make you confused. You see how stupid what you just said? So Muhammad, he explained too much, and now he think, because he explained too much, the Muslim Abdul are stupid. Have you ever heard of such explanation will make you confused? That's what you just said. So he told you too much, and now because he told you too much, you became confused. And now he will fix it. How? By saying more much. How stupid is that? And now Muhammad saying more much and saying what? More confusing stuff. Because we agree that you need to explain it to me because I'm confused.
Okay. Now can I answer?
Go ahead.
So if I tell you A is to 1, 1 is to A is equal to 1, 1 is equal to, there are so many. There is simple A is to 1. You can remember that, okay? So in this, the one thing that Hazrat Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has told his prophets, told his companions is that he is one eyed. Just remember this, and your Lord is not one eyed. Just remember this, and you will identify the true Dajjal when
he comes.
So
have?
He has cleared all the doubts
of his companions. How many eyes Allah have?
We don't know. We have not seen Allah. No one has.
No, hold on.
Seen Allah. No, Prophet Muhammad
said. No. Okay. Did Muhammad see Allah?
No, he didn't see Allah.
Okay, how he knew this?
Because Allah told him.
Where?
Of course, you know information.
Where?
You're questioning every information I am telling.
Why not? Hold on. And then Muhammad now he accomplished what? He accomplished that Allah is not one-eyed. But that make us more confused now, because Allah is not one-eyed. That will make him what? Many-eyed God?
Okay, when you question every information that I give, you say why not? And when the Dawa people questions everything, you say them bad words, right?
This verse should say, because this guy, he claimed to be the Messiah, correct? He claimed to be a true Messiah. Okay, so is the Messiah, the true Messiah, is a man?
Wait a minute. Right.
Okay, so shouldn't Muhammad say, if you are confused about him, between him and the true Messiah, you should see them, you know, the Messiah, he looked like this. So Muhammad, he is saying clearly that God is the Messiah, because they are confused, because the guy is not claiming to be God. His name is Al-Masih al-Dajjal. He claimed to be the Messiah. So he's claiming to be the Messiah. But Muhammad right away, he's saying to them, well, by claiming to be the Messiah, he's claiming to be God, for Messiah is God. So now you need to know, might be confused, because now he claimed to be the Messiah and that make him God. Secondly, he looked like the Messiah, and that will make him look like God. And now I'm going to give you a trick to find out that he is not really the true Messiah. How? Simply, he is not Messiah. The true Messiah, the true Lord, is not one-eyed. So here, the only way to make it happen to be working fine is to say that the true Lord, the Messiah, is not one-eyed, because the comparison have to be between two men who have eyes. This is why your prophet is telling you. This is why your prophet telling you how tall he is, how his physical body look like, and the only problem, he did not say your God is not not tall, not short. He did not say Allah is not short. His hair is not curly. He is describing the Messiah, which they will be confused about him, to be the Lord. What is the only difference from all the description? The eye.
I have already answered you this question, that
let us go back to zero. So now your prophet, he have a surgery. Allah, he installed a dish of wisdom. Why Allah installed faith in his chest?
I already told you, so that he may believe that there exists one God.
Okay, so
no other deity.
So you are saying to me, Muhammad, before the surgery, he don't believe.
Yeah, he didn't believe that Allah is one, because he didn't knew.
Okay, is that fair that your God, he will install? Guys, listen carefully to this. Muhammad, he started believing in Islam after Allah, he installed faith in his chest. That's what you just said, correct?
No, actually, he never believed in the Arabic gods. Because there's a incident in which Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam even forbid himself to not eat the food which was cut it by the name of other gods. So he always had something in mind that there is only one God, but he didn't know, like Abraham, that what is the God's name and how to pray to him, how to make
him happy. So he believes in God, but he does not know what the God name. Uh-huh. So he is the son of a guy, his name is Abdullah, and Muhammad do not know the name yet. So how his father is Abdullah, the slave of Allah?
So
my father, his name is Abdullah, slave of Allah. And now I am the son. I do not know what is the name of the God of my father. What is a joke?
Wait. Let me search. Uh-huh. What was his father's name?
Okay, search for.
Okay, father's name of Prophet Muhammad.
So you are explaining to me Islam, and you do not know the name of your father, your prophet father. And you have all the answers, you know, you're a genius. Okay, you're a genius. You do not know the name of the Muhammad father. Okay, let us go down.
No, I just wanted to confirm.
Okay, hold on. You're good to confirm. So now you are saying that after Allah, he installed the faith, Muhammad now, you know the name of the God.
No.
You said that a second ago, you forgot.
Okay, it is not, you know, the names can be changed.
Okay, tell us, the word Allah. Okay, when Allah, he installed the faith, what happened to Muhammad? What faith, this faith, he put it inside his chest. Okay, what this faith will do now inside Muhammad? Go ahead.
So, actually, if for this answer, I would like to say that I don't know much about the history. So, I don't know that if Allah was, the word Allah existed before Islam started or not.
So, I thought Abraham, you worship Allah. So, before, you don't know now?
Yeah, he worship Allah.
Allah is exist. Okay. But now I want you to explain to me. Okay, now listen. Allah installed wisdom so Muhammad can explain the Quran. Correct?
Yes.
Do you know what the word sex means?
You just gave answer to your own question that Abraham.
Do you know what the word sex means?
Yeah. Okay. What's the word?
According to science.
No.
According to science, if the man have orgasm first, the baby will be a boy. If the women have orgasm first, the baby will be a girl. Do you agree with this science? Or this is stupid science?
So, have you tried that? Because we cannot know if we don't try.
Oh, we have to try it first. Okay, so I need to find the women now.
Yeah.
Okay, so now I'm going to find the women, and I will do that with her, and I will let you know after 9 months. Listen, I'm asking you. Yes. According to science. Yeah. According to science. If somebody says to me,
According to science, it is not like that.
It's not like that. Thank you very much. But your prophet, he said this. Everybody heard you. According to science, it's not like that. Here we go. Remember, you said that the prophet, after Allah, he installed wisdom, now he can explain the Quran. And now your prophet explained the Quran. So he said, the messenger of Allah said, the man water is thick and white. Listen, and the woman water is thin and yellow. Whichever of them comes first, the child resembles the parents.
Science doesn't know everything. I study science.
A second ago, you said science does not agree with this. This is wrong. Now you bite your tongue back and you say, "Oh, science does not know everything."
Yes, I never said that science. Science no.
You just said it's recorded.
I never said
it's recorded. You said the one who say this is wrong. It's you who said that. The one who says if the man have orgasm first, the baby will be a boy is wrong.
I didn't say that. I said
you
that
said
science
that.
Does
it's
not.
Recorded. It's recorded.
Science does not say. I said science does not say that. You can ask. You can ask
exactly.
To your
you said science
friends.
Okay.
What
you
is
said science doesn't say that. You said science doesn't say that. So science is against this. Correct.
Yes.
Okay, so Muhammad is wrong.
No. Science is correct. Science is correct in everything, but it doesn't know everything.
Okay, but is it wrong here or right? About if you have orgasm first, the baby will be a boy. If the women have orgasm first, the baby will be a guy. And the one who control that simply is the thick water of the man, which is the sperm. And women, they have a sperm, which is yellow and thin.
Yes,
you
know, eggs are yellow.
Oh, eggs are yellow.
You know?
Okay, and they come out of the vagina. And they come out of the vagina.
Yeah, you can Google it. You can Google it.
Okay, guys. But here it says water. It says water. The water of the woman. Water. Is the egg is water? Like the woman, she have an eggs like a fish. She have like a billion egg. She have one egg.
So, okay. First, you tell me that sperm of a woman is yellow, and now you are saying water of woman
my
is
friend,
yellow.
Is women so have, do women have a sperm anyway?
You said that, okay? I don't say
no,
that.
Your prophet,
women have
your prophet saying that. Your prophet saying that the one have orgasm first, the baby will resemble him, so or her. So the water of the man is thick, and this is the semen. So he said the same water, and this is ejaculation, and the woman water is yellow, and that is ejaculation too, and you will see it in the woman vagina. Whoever of them comes first, the baby will resemble the parents. How in the world, Muhammad, after installing a surgery, doing a surgery of wisdom, he says such a stupid thing?
Let me search the whole hadith. You have the hadith you have sent me is not all. So
not all?
Let's see.
No problem. Yes. I can show you Quran. Do you want to show you Quran? I can help you.
No, I will help myself.
I will help you more, my friend. I help you more. Here we go. Chapter 86. Chapter 86. Verse number.
You only help in a negative way.
No problem. Okay, we see. Verse number 6 and verse number 7 says, فَلْيَنْظُرَ الْإِنسَانَ مِمَّا خُلِقَ مِنْ مَاءٍ دَافِقٍ يَخْرُجُ مِنْ بَيْنِ الصُّلْبِ وَالتَّرَائِبِ. So let the man see what is created. He's a created from water gushing forth. This is orgasm coming out. It's not an egg. It's a gushing forth. It's ejaculation. Proceeding from proceeding from between the backbone and the ribs. So the man have a backbone. This is where the sperm coming from. The women, she have a ribs, and this is where the sperm coming from. Do you agree that women, she have testicles in her ribs?
No, a woman does not have testicle, but how do you think this verse is wrong?
Because women, their sperm have nothing to do. You are the one who said to me women have an egg, correct?
No. In this verse, you said the gushing fluid one verse.
Yeah, so what about it? It's a gushing forth.
How's it wrong?
This is not the one is wrong. Hold on. That's not only the one is wrong. Gushing forth, nothing wrong with it, because a man have ejaculation. Okay. Now the question is, it says he is created from water gushing forth, and this water, which is gushing forth, ejaculation, coming from the backbone of the man and the ribs of the women.
Okay. Let me see. I will see myself. I will see myself.
Okay. Here we go. And I will show you even the interpretation, so you don't say we are making things up. Here we go.
Yeah, no problem. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
Yeah, you need to say
they were created from a spurting fluid stemming, emerging from between the backbone and the ribs.
Okay.
They were created from a spurting fluid emerging from between the backbone and the ribs.
Okay.
So is this wrong? Is this wrong?
So is the sperm of the man coming from the backbone?
No. But is it wrong? You say yes or no. I will prove.
For sure it's wrong, because the sperm is not coming from the backbone of the man.
Okay. Now, can I prove you wrong?
Okay, go ahead.
Okay. You first go in Google and search the word emerge and know its meaning, what it means. Mm-hmm. Emerge means to come out.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. So come out where? Come out where?
Yes?
Come out where?
Let me tell you. Okay. Now go to Google and write.
Don't go to Google, my friend. I speak Arabic. Arabic is my first language. I do not need to translate that word. So I'm asking you now. Okay. It come out where?
No, you speak Arabic, but you do not speak science.
My friend,
so
I don't speak science. I'm not a scientist. You are the genius. I'm asking you. It come out.
Yeah,
come out where? Come out where? Very simple. Don't tell me search Google. It come out where?
Yeah, I just want you to see the transportation of sperm, then you will know.
I'm asking you, it come out where?
Okay, so you are asking me, let me tell you, but you will not believe me. Okay.
Okay.
The sperms, when they leave the, you know, when they leave the testicles, they go straight above, they do not leave the body.
Did you just say, when they leave the testicles?
Yes.
Okay. So why Allah did not say this? Because he said backbone.
Let me clear your doubts.
Okay.
Okay. So when they leave the testicles, they do not, they do not leave the body directly. They go up all the way up from the penis, and they take U-turn. You know U-turn. They take U-turn. And then they go towards the penis. So when they go towards the penis, what is their direction? Their direction is from the center of the ribs and backbone towards the penis. So it is emerging out of
the sperm of the man coming. go to the ribs.
Yes.
Oh, that's something.
So do you understand?
Now I understand, but my friend, the Quran says no. The Quran says that the ribs is the ribs of the women, and you are a fool. First, this is not what the Quran is saying. What you said to me is it's just stupid kids talking. Read with me carefully. He created
from... I told you science.
Shut up and listen and read now. It's time to school you. He is created from water gushing forth, and this is your scholar, Ibn Kathir. And he is explaining to you based on what Muhammad said. So, he created from gushing forth, meaning the sexual fluid that come out bursting forth from the men and the women. So, the baby is created from sexual fluid coming out from the men and the women. Okay, thus the child is produced from both of them by permission of Allah. And he continues saying, يَخْرُجُ مِنْ بَيْنِ الصُّلْبِ وَالتَّرَائِبِ, proceeding from between the backbone and the ribs. He said, meaning the backbone of the man and the ribs of the women. Because the word taraib is a word used for women ribs.
Is this Ibn Kathir talking?
Yes, this is Ibn Kathir using the reference of your prophet. He's using the hate of your prophet. Okay. Mm-hmm. And this is the link.
Who was Ibn Kathir? Was he some companion of prophet?
He's just an idiot YouTuber, you know. He opened a channel on YouTube 800 years after Muhammad, and he wanted to refute the Christians, and now he's a genius. He's using Muhammad words to refute us, and he got us busted, as you see, because this is the discovery that women, they have a sperm coming from the bone of the man, the backbone.
Okay, everyone has their own interpretation.
This is not his interpretation. This is the interpretation of your prophet, because he is quoting your prophet.
Okay, show me the hadith where prophet says that. Okay. I will be.
All right, that is okay.
Show me the hadith where prophet says that. Not Ibn Kathir.
Okay. Show me, guys. Show me where the prophet says that. So now, if we show you where the prophet says that, you are not going to oppose.
Yes. The prophet directly says himself.
All right. Okay. Let's go and see the prophet saying. All right. this one is da'if. I don't want to show you da'if. Okay, let us see. Anyway, this is not the one I want. All right, let us read this hadith, and I will give you the link. Let us read this hadith, and this is sahih. A woman, her name is Ummu Salama. Ummu Salim, sorry. She came to Muhammad.
Can you send me?
Okay, let me send the link. Ummu Salim went to the Messenger of Allah. This is a woman. She offered herself to have sex with the Prophet later. And she said, Apostle of Allah, Allah is not ashamed of truth. Is bathing necessary for a woman when she see a sexual dream? So what happened to this woman? She was touching her vagina. She was enjoying herself. Upon that, the Messenger of Allah said, when she see the liquid between two bracket, the vaginal circumcision, she have to wash. So this is what? This is a water in the vagina. It's orgasm. Okay. Ummu Salama, she said to the Messenger, this is the wife of Muhammad, Allah Messenger, does a woman have a sexual dream? And the fact, by the way, doesn't say, she did not say really that. She said, Does the woman have orgasm? Not tahtalim, not to see sexual dream. It says tahtalim, which means to have a sexual orgasm. The Prophet, he said, yes. Otherwise, and he insulted her. He says, cover your hand with dust. In what way then does her child resemble her? So your prophet claim that the women liquid in her vagina is the one responsible for having a baby, and the baby look like her. And that is
asked you where Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about that verse. This is not about that verse.
Well, it's in there, because you know, you said to me, show me where your prophet says that. Your prophet hadith is quoted here. Read carefully with me. You are not reading, my friend. Read as good.
This is about sexual dream. Yeah, it is not about where does gushing liquid come.
Okay, hold on. No, it's about a sexual dream, but he said this is about how the baby made. It's about a sexual liquid in her vagina, and it's yellow. Let us show you different. Hold on. But let's go to Ibn Kathir. If we go to Ibn Kathir, it says here.
Means you are going to
read carefully. Read carefully. Read carefully here. All right. It's a yellow. And fine in texture. The child will not be born except from both of them. Who is the one saying that? This is your prophet. Do we agree?
Yes, the child will not be born from both of them.
Okay. So it's yellow and fine in texture. And that is what the women ejaculation. Do we agree?
Yes, woman ejaculation is yellow.
Is it scientific true that women ejaculation and the water coming out from her vagina is the one who made the baby, or it is an egg inside we don't see?
No, it doesn't say about the woman. It says about the sperm. From sperm the baby is born.
No, it says it's a woman, and the woman water is thin and yellow. What's wrong with you? Let me show you again. Hold on, I mean, you Muslims, you have no shame of keep lying non-stop and people are laughing. Read carefully again.
We don't like
read carefully. This is your interpretation, this is your problem, not mine. And your prophet is the one giving the interpretation to your scholars. They cannot say things up to them. They have to say according to the prophet.
No.
The prophet, you say so.
Hold on.
Let us see. Ma'ur rajul. Read carefully. Ma'ur rajul. The water of the man is thin. Sorry, thick and white. Does it say that?
Yes, it says that.
Okay. And the women waters is thin and yellow. Does it say that?
Yes.
Okay. Whichever of them comes first, okay? It is about the coming, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Now we go back to the previous hadith where Muhammad, he explained to the woman about what she see in the dream. If she see that water which is yellow in her vagina, she have to wash. The wife, she asked, do the women have this charge? He said to her, yes. Otherwise, how the baby resemble her? So the water, which is the discharge coming from the woman, is if she come first, the baby will resemble the mother. Do we agree?
Yes.
Okay, but this is what science teach? Or this is stupid?
What?
Is that what science teach?
No.
Or this is stupid? Okay, don't you Muslims circumcise women, which means women, they never have orgasm. So how she will have orgasm? No, women, they don't have orgasm. Look, read with me. Even the wife prophet, he never made her have orgasm. The wife of Muhammad, she said, and do the women have orgasm? Do the women have discharge? Read carefully. Ummu Salama, the wife of your prophet, says, this is the wife of Muhammad. Muhammad, he never gave her one orgasm. Read carefully. Ummu Salama smiled and said, does a woman get discharged? This is the wife exposing Muhammad. He cannot have sex. Does the woman have discharge? The woman, she is the wife, sleeping with Muhammad bed every day, and she is asking the husband, what this woman she is talking about? Women, they have this charge.
Okay, now can I answer?
Okay, go answer.
Now can I answer?
Go ahead.
So, you know, science says that women also discharge.
Okay.
Science says that.
Okay.
You can go study.
I know women have discharge. I know that women have don't need to study. I know women have discharge. But this is not the question, you idiot. The question is that the discharge which is coming out in the vagina, the yellow thin water, is what make the baby. And this is what make the baby even a female. So the man has a sperm, the man has a sperm and it's white. The woman has a sperm and it's yellow. The woman's sperm coming from her ribs. That's what the Quran is saying, chapter 86, verse number 6 and 7 and 8.
Where is the sperm used? What is the word sperm used? You keep assuming from yourself.
Okay, well, your prophet saying this is how the son resembled the father then, or the mother?
Yes, this is the, you know, of her.
Abdul, listen. Listen. Is the Quran using the word water for sperm? Does the Quran use the word water for a sperm?
Yes.
Okay. Does your prophet
here
use, does your prophet use here the word water?
Yes, for male.
So it's a sperm. So why are you playing a fool now?
Yes.
Number three. I want you to search right now in Google and tell me how long the sperm live inside a woman after sex.
Okay. I will do it for you.
Okay, give me an answer, please help me.
How long? Does the sperm live in woman?
Okay.
Sperm woman.
What Google told you?
Okay, when sperm are alive inside woman's body, they can live for up to 5 days. Are a man and so, you have sex, even
okay.
After.
I have a friend. He is you know, a Middle Eastern, not educated. He said that he had sex with his wife, and he did not have sex with her for 40 days, and then after that, one of his sperm, which was inside her, made her have a baby. Do you agree with that?
Yes.
You agree.
Yes.
He's a Christian.
Yes, I agree.
You agree.
Because he's not only referring to the sperm, he's referring to all the nutrients that will be given to sperm.
No, he's
to maturity.
He's referring only to the sperm. He said after 40 days the sperm did boom boom and they made her, you know, the woman have a baby. You agree with that?
Okay. Yes, according to science, it's no, but, you know...
According to science, it's no, but no. Yeah, because, you know, look how hypocrite you are. Just because you know that your prophet is the one who said that, you know what is coming. So you say, I agree with him. Okay, read carefully on love. So Google says...
Shut up, Abdul.
Come on, shame on you. People are laughing. This is how you change your statement in a second. The second your prophet says...
So listen.
Okay, I ask you, can you search for me in Google how long the sperm can live inside the woman? You said 5 days. Do you agree?
Yes.
Did your prophet say that sperm live inside the woman for 40 days?
Show me the hadith.
The truthful, the messenger of Allah, the truthful and the receiver of the truth. Remember, he received the truth. They installed with truth inside them. They installed wisdom now and knowledge. Informed us saying, the creation of you, human, is gathered in the form of a semen in the mother belly, not womb, fi batni ummi, to the up to 40 days.
Let me search there.
What search? Already you told us that a sperm can live for 5 days maximum. And now this is your prophet, after the surgery, after Allah, he made a surgery for his penis and his chest and his whatever. Now Muhammad is wise. The wise Muhammad is making poo-poo.
So I do not find any hadith. Can you show me?
Okay, let me
show you. Here I am searching.
Don't search. No need to search. Here we go. Let me send it to you. Here we go. I will send it to you. Here we go. Open it and read it. Go ahead. And remember, all those stupid things happened after Muhammad, he got a plastic surgery for his chest, installing wisdom and faith. So if this is after the surgery, let me see.
Hmm. And after that, I would also like to know why you become so pessimistic.
I like comedy all my life. I like comedy. What do you think about the prophet says to me that my penis will be endless?
That the creation of you humans is gathered in the form of semen in the womb of your mother for 40 days. Yeah. The creation of you humans is gathered in the form of semen in the womb for you. The creation does not come from semen. Semen is given nutrients from all around the body. It is 40 days. You can't see sperm. It does not say the sperm is collected.
No, it says that. It says it's collecting. You are collected as a semen. You are collected in the form of a semen. Stop lying. It's in the front of your eye. It's gathered. It's gathered in a form of semen. Potato. You see, I'm having patience with you. Because we are out of potatoes, and you are the only potato who call me. But you are the most stupid potato ever I spoke to, I have to admit.
Yeah.
I mean, it doesn't say that. It's in the front of your eyes. It's gathered just shut up, man. Just go. Let your dad call me. Stupid idiot. See how much patience you need to when you talk to those idiots? And people, they say to me, you don't have patient. If I don't have patient, who have patient? If any of you talk to this guy 2 minutes, you will lose your mind. I mean, they keep defending, lying, and it's in the front of them. The prophet said the sun set in a muddy water. No, it's a metaphorical. Look, what metaphorical? The sun travels, goes. Hey, it goes under the throne of Allah, but don't you know how the throne of Allah? Okay, the throne of Allah, hold on, let's go there. Allah, he go down to the lowest heaven. Is Allah moving? They are like a chicken from a branch to a branch, and the only way is to cut their wings, and we do. So I had patience with you, my friend, to show everybody how fool you are. Doesn't say semen in Arabic? No, it does. It says nutfa. Nutfa is a drop of semen. You're a dummy like your prophet. It doesn't say semen in Arabic. No, it does. Nutfa. And Muhammad actually is quoting the Quran, idiot. So you are 40 days as a nutfa. And nutfa is a drop of semen. Let us go to the Quran and show you. Get you busted, Abdul. Potato. A bunch of potatoes. خلق الإنسان من نطفة. You see it? نطفة. علقة. نطفة. Read carefully, Abdul. ثم خلقنا النطفة علقة. We made the sperm into a congealed blood. This is what nutfa means. Nutfa is a drop of a sperm. So you are collected. Now we can go to the interpretation. Everybody will laugh at you. Because if the word sperm is not there, if the word semen is not there, then no interpretation should mention it. Stupidity. So you see how desperate they are trying? Oh, it doesn't say there in Arabic semen. You know what? I mean, this is an answer of a stupid fool, because if it does not, why you Muslims say it's a semen? You idiot. If it does not say that, why you Muslim, in your Muslim website, you translate it as semen? If it was zucchini. I mean, do you see the stupidity, guys? It doesn't say in a form, get lost, get lost. Get out of here. That means you Muslims are a bunch of liars. Get out of here. Because if you say it doesn't say that, it's mean you Muslims, you lie about what your prophet is saying. Thank you. Each time a Muslim says it doesn't say that, you see, for me, it's okay to say that because I accuse Muslim to lie defending Islam. But you idiot, when you say it doesn't say that, it's mean you Muslims, you lie about your translation. You get the point? If I say it doesn't say that, people understand I'm a Christian trying to get them busted with their false translation. But you Muslim complain about the Muslim translation because the Muslim translation got you busted. And you know what? I'm going to give you a solution for this. You are receive the true, okay, and then he says, you are the creation of you, a human, gathered in a form, I will take the word semen, in the womb. What is that? For 40 days. Take the word semen, I will take it off. Give me the replacement for semen, you idiot. Just give me a replacement, because now it's not semen. If it's not form, give me a translation. Cowards, shameful. The only way for Islam to live is to lie. Without lie, Islam die. So we have to jump like monkeys from a place to a place, trying to deny all the stupid things Muhammad he said. This is different hadith. This is Sahih Muslim. This is your translation. It doesn't say that, CP. This is your translation. It doesn't say that, CP. This is your Muslim. This doesn't say that, CP. Okay. The creation of any of you is like this, that semen is collected, here it says a womb, at the mother of the mother for 40 nights. Do you see it? So again, you're Muslim, you make the same mistake, you keep saying semen, you idiot. Shame on you. You are fired. I'm not going to hire a Muslim to translate the hadith of the Prophet, no more. Shame on you. The Prophet says, okay, you put semen. The Prophet says, a cucumber, you put semen. The Prophet says, falafel, you put semen. What's wrong with you? You're stuck with semen, aren't you? Ah, you are a semen person. Anything for those translators is a semen. Semen nation. You see, in the form of a nutfa. What is nutfa? Is a drop. Drop of what? Drop of semen. Idiot. So you are a semen for 40 days, and then you are a semen as a dead blood for 40 days. And then you are a lump for 40 days. The total is 120 days. Dr. Muhammad, after the surgery, is more stupid than before the surgery. Remember the guy, he said, Allah, he installed the wisdom in the Prophet so he can explain the Quran, brother. He can understand the Quran, brother. Why Allah did not make surgery for Isa and for Moses and for Abraham? I mean, how stupid Muhammad was to the point he needed plastic surgery to fix him. What you are confirming to us, that Muhammad is not qualified like the others to explain Allah's words, to understand Allah's words, to the point Allah, he needed to make a plastic surgery for him. He was so fool, so stupid, so dummy, to the point, I cannot send him like this to be a messenger. I need to fix him. So what Allah he do? He sent a messenger, sorry, a doctor, an angel, and this angel, he cut open his chest, and then he bring a dish of faith. What a shameful statement. Muhammad have no faith. This guy who called us, he said Muhammad before that day, he don't even know the name of Allah. So how Muhammad get the name of Allah? The angel, he installed a dish, and the dish there, it says, Allah, God name is Allah. Look at this genius. How Muhammad knew the name of his God? He didn't know the name. Allah, he got a dish of faith. He put it in the chest of the Prophet, and the Prophet opened his eyes, and then he started saying, Alhamdulillah. Hey Muhammad, do you want to eat? Alhamdulillah. Hey Muhammad, Zakir Naik is here. Well, Alhamdulillah. Christian Prince is here. It's not Alhamdulillah. But this is stupidity. And isn't it Muslim, they say, if Allah, he wants something, he say, B is going to be? Huh? Isn't it the Quran says, if Allah wants something to happen, he say, kun fayakun, B is going to be? Chapter number 2, verse 117. If Allah wants something to happen, he said to it, be, and it is. So how come Allah could not make Muhammad faithful without a surgery? How Allah could not make Muhammad wise without a surgery? Who is the foolish here? Either this story is fabricated by Muhammad, or this story is true. If it's true, this is contradiction for the Quran. Because Allah, he don't need to do this. Allah, he said to Muhammad, be wise, he will be wise. Ah, I forgot. Allah, he said to Muhammad, read. Still Muhammad, he died, he cannot read according to Muslims. Not like Jesus. Jesus said to the dead man, raise from the grave, he rose. Jesus said to the man who cannot walk, walk, he woke. See, he saw. Allah, he squeezed Muhammad 3 times. Still Muhammad, he says to him, I cannot read. And the idiot in Jibreel kept squeezing him. I mean, did you get enough for squeezing? All the stories of Muhammad are stupid. When the angel, he squeezed Muhammad first time, and he told him, read. Do the angels know that Muhammad do not know how to read? Huh? Okay, Muhammad told him now, I cannot read. Let's say the angel was stupid. He told him, according to Muslim, I do not know how to read. Why the angel keeps squeezing him again and says, read? Stupid story. And he squeezed him until the guy, the poor Muhammad, cannot breathe. Read carefully. The angel come to him, and he asked him to read. The Prophet replied, I do not know how to read. Then the Prophet said, the angel cut me forcefully, and he pressed me so hard until I could not breathe anymore. Then he released me. What a squeezing party. Muslims, anyone knows why the angel squeezed Muhammad? Anyone knows? It's a challenge for the Muhammadan to tell me why the angel squeezed Muhammad. What the connection between squeezing Muhammad and reading? The angel said, read. Muhammad said to him, I can't read. Why is he squeezing him? The angel again repeating, saying, read. Muhammad said, I cannot read. He squeezed him again. Why? The angel, he said to him 3rd time, read. Muhammad, he said, what the heck with this guy? I can't read. And he squeezed him for the 3rd time. First, why it's a 3 time? Number 2, what squeezing did to Muhammad? Did he understand now anything? No. Muhammad, he went to his wife, he's scared, terrified. She took him to her daddy, Uncle Waraka, which is the real father of Muhammad. She told him, this guy, look what he saw. Explain to him, Muhammad, tell him what happened. The guy who did not see the angel, he was not squeezed by, well, no mayonnaise came out. Waraka bin Ufal, he is not the guy being squeezed. He told him, this is Jibreel. Look, what the heck? The guy who was not there, he is more guided from the Prophet. The guy who is not even a Muslim, he knew this is Jibreel. The one who been squeezed, He is the last one to know. Muhammad is always the last one to know. His wife sleeping with Safwan, he is the last one to know. Muslims reciting Quran wrong, he is the last one to know. Shaitan give him satanic verses, he is the last one to know. Any Abdul? Why he squeezed him 3 times? Nobody can answer the question. And you know what? If Allah is the one, who is the one saying, read, this is Allah. Is it Allah who told Jibreel, when you say to him, read, and he say, I don't know, squeeze him? Okay, it must be Allah, because Jibreel don't do things from his own. So what this squeezing did? Did Muhammad understood after the squeezing what is happening, what's going on? No, still he's ignorant. So what this story is about? And not to forget to mention, he is an Indonesian. How you know he's Indonesian? Did you speak to him, Carolina? Did you speak to him? Mostly this is Ultimate Fort, the kid from Nigeria. All the story is a stupid story. And by the way, where in the hadith it says he said to him, read? He did not say to him, read. Isn't it the Muslim that say the word Iqra al-Quran mean to recite the Quran? So how he said to him, read? Obviously the stupid Muhammad did not know Arabic very well. The correct answer, yes, he said to him, Iqra, which is read, not recite. Because Qara'a is an Aramaic word coming from the two words, Qarra wa Ra'a. Ra'a mean he saw, Qarra he said. So he said what he saw, not he what he heard. So if the angel did not give him papers, why he saying to him to read? And if he gave him papers, why he said to someone who do not know how to read, read? And if it's recitation, that would be stupid more. Why? Because Muhammad already, he recited what the angel said. The angel said to him, Iqra. Muhammad, he says, I cannot do Iqra. He just recited. So it doesn't make sense. Guys, look at this. Look at this. Look at the smart answer. The reason, brother, look how much they squeeze their head to come with an answer. This is a new answer now. Look at this. The reason that Jibreel, brother, he squeezed him because the prophet, he saw him before in a dream. So to show him that this is the reality, not a dream, you idiot. He's, the guy is asleep. He's not. Secondly, I will go with you. He's squeezing first time. Is it enough? Second time, is it enough? After 3 dreams, did your prophet get it? Still no. He's squeezing 3 times, still he do not know what's happening. So this is a silly answer. Your prophet was not asleep. Your prophet squeezed not only once. After 3 squeezes, still Muhammad do not know who is this guy, and he have no idea what's happening. So to show him, did he show him? He did not. He failed. The guy, he went to his wife. He said to her, cover me, cover me. He start making crazy noise. His body is shaking. His muscle is shaking. He have epilepsy. It's obvious. Muhammad is mentally ill, and it's proven by Muslims' mouth and their books. All Muslims agree that Muhammad, he was bewitched, and he imagined seeing things. In fact, he never did. Is that true? Absolutely. Which is proving that Muhammad, obviously, all the stories he said is from his imagination. Read with me carefully, and this is Sahih al-Bukhari, which is very authentic. It says, once the prophet was bewitched, so he began to imagine that he had done a thing which in fact he had not done. anyone who study, he's a doctor, he will know that there is, this is a symptom of something bigger. Hearing voices, imagining doing things, this is a symptom of something else. The Arab at that time, they cannot explain it, so they say somebody put magic on him. But here Muhammad's case or symptoms became so clear to the point everybody noticed that he is just imagining things. Now, as long the wife and the Muslims agree that Muhammad, he imagined things, in fact, those things never happened. How we can trust the Quran he received? When I was in the army, there's a person who was released from the army for a very simple reason, hear voices. He hear voices. He talked to them. They talked to him. That is Muhammad. Kus are saying that the prophet was bewitched for 6 or 12 months. Look what you just did, my friend. You just destroyed Islam. And actually, you know, like we have recording a video of a debate with a Muslim. He says the same as you said. It was a 12 month, took Allah 12 months to release the bewitching of Muhammad. But hold on, Muhammad at that time was receiving Quran. So Muhammad was receiving Quran, seeing Jibreel for 12 months, and he was not seeing Jibreel. Because you just said it took Allah 12 months, and look how weak is Allah. I mean, this religion is the most stupid cult ever. How in the Quran it says if Allah wants something, he say B is going to be. Huh? B is going to be. Chapter 2, verse 117. And then it took Allah all this time to fix Muhammad bewitching. Like what happened? Allah, he went to his kitchen. What we will do now? We have to send him verse after verse after verse, and that will cure him. Twelve months of Allah sending verses, giving Muhammad medicine. After 12 months, Muhammad was cured? He was not, still stupid. 1 year Muhammad is receiving revelation, or it was imagination. Actually, even Muhammad's sex was fake, because the hadith says so. The hadith says that Muhammad, he imagined himself having sex. In fact, he never did. Read carefully. Aisha is the sex reporter. Thank God that at that time there's no Facebook. Other Aisha, she will publish all the laundry of Muhammad in Facebook. I mean, this woman, there was no Facebook at that time, and look what she's doing. All the laundry of Muhammad is out. Hey, people, the prophet, he cannot have sex. He imagined himself having sex with us, but in fact, he was not. He was holding the pillow. Sometimes he hold the goat. Allahu Akbar, please publish this in Twitter. I mean, this woman is a scandal by herself. What kind of a woman, she go in the street and she tell the situation of her husband's penis? Is she proud? So if Kuzer, our friend Kuzer here, it says, it affects only special life. What is the proof? If he is bewitched, it means he is under the control. He is imagining, it says, he imagined he done a thing, in fact he did not. Even his sex is fake. What's wrong with bewitched? Look at this guy. Secondly, how Allah, he protected Muhammad, and then he is bewitched. It affects only one thing. Who says so? Like what, his penis? Can you give us the list of things it's affecting Muhammad because of the bewitching, brother? I want you to write for me the list. I will put it in the screen. I promise you. What is exactly was affecting Muhammad by bewitching? Write a list for us, please. If you don't mind. As you see, it's affecting his penis. What else? He had the Donna thing, but in fact he did not. So the guy is imaginary. Everything, even his action, you know, he imagined he did. He lost his mind. CP only refutes Sunni. He cannot refute Shia. There's no need to refute Shia. Shia refute themselves. Did you see the video I just made a few weeks ago about the Muslim Shia Imam quoting the hadith that Muslim Sunni, they are homosexual because Shaitan, he put finger in his in their anus? Why? Because they are not Shia. Allah don't protect them. Who said they don't? Shia or Sunni, they have the same stupid stories. If you go right now to the Arabian Prophet account, other account I have, you will see how the Shia scholar, Sheikh Yasir al-Habib, saying that Muslim Sunni, because they are Muslim Sunni, Allah don't protect them. And how and why? Because simply they are not Shia, brother. So he allows Shaitan to finger them. Finger the Muslim Sunni, and he make all the Sunni homosexual. My internet is not doing good. I'm trying to play the thing for you, but it's not working. You know, I never thought about, hold on, let's see him, which is very funny. I mean, to him in the
لاحظوا ما رواه العياشي عن إمامنا جعفر بن محمد الصادق صلوات.
This is coming from Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq. Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq saying, this is like God for them, you know, Ja'far al-Sadiq. He is saying that the Sunni are homosexual because this is what Al-Imam Al-Ayyashi, he reported from the Imam Ja'far al-Sadiq. May Allah pray on him.
الله عليهما يقول ما من مولود يولد إلا وإبليس من الأبالسة بحضرته.
Not a single person he was giving birth, but yet one of the Iblis, which is Shaitan, Satan, he is next to him in the present of his time of, you know, his mother giving birth to him.
يكون واحد من الأبالسة يكون حاضر في وقت ولادة المولود.
One of the Satans, he will be exist in the time of giving birth for this new infant. This is a must. Okay, go ahead.
فإن علم الله أنه من شيعتنا إن علم الله أن هذا المولود من شيعتنا حجبه من ذلك الشيطان.
If Allah knew, which is very funny, I mean, so Allah do not know. I thought Allah is the one who decide if he will be Shia or Sunni. So if Allah, he knew that this baby or new baby, newborn baby, he is going to be a Shia, Allah will hide him from Shaitan. That's it. The Shaitan who is there, yes, he is in the room, but because he is Shia, Allah will hide him. Okay.
الله يحجبه من ذلك الشيطان.
Allah will put a veil on him so Shaitan cannot see him.
طان فلا يتمكن الشيطان من أن يطعن فيه أو يؤذي.
So Shaitan, when Allah he hide this baby because he's a Shia, that's why Allah protect him. Shaitan cannot punish him and he cannot do harm to him.
وإن لم يكن من شيعتنا.
And if he is not a Shia.
أثبت الشيطان إصبعه السبابة في دبره.
And then, if he is not a Shia, which means a Muslim Sunni like Abu Bakr, Umar, all those Muslim Sunni, you see them in YouTube, Allah will make the shaitan put his finger in their anus.
فَكَانَ مَأْبُونًا.
And that will make him a gay. All right, where is the guy who said you cannot do that to the Shia? You have the most funny stories. According to your hadith, if a person who wear yellow, black shoes, his penis will not stand up. Al-Mahdi, if he fail, he will fail in his ass and he will not fart. A man, if he have sex with his wife from behind and he look at her, his son will become a mute. You Shia are supposed to have a better stories? No funny. And Muslim Sunni, they are no better. They are the same garbage too. I mean, both of you. And all of this is coming from your Prophet Muhammad, supposedly. But, you know, what Muslims are busy about is how Prophet of Allah look like. Oh, hold on. How Prophet of Allah look like. How Prophet of Allah look like.
And for some, this would be the first time you hear what your Prophet looked like. I saw a man of striking appearance.
Look at the action. And look at the back effect news, like a sound. I saw a man with a striking. It's like a gay club, man. I mean, this is describing for a man.
ظاهر الوضاء أبلج الوجه radiant face حسن الخلق beautifully created لم تعبه الثجلة. His belly wasn't protruding.
It's very important to tell us about the belly of Muhammad. I mean, we need details, my brother. Do you have more details? Testicles, penis, his ass. Do you have more details? Fingers. Well, what else you want to ask? His belly? What about his belly bomb? Come on. I mean, we arrived at the belly. Don't stop there.
وَلَمْ تُزْرِ بِهِ السَّعْلَ.
He would describe even his cuff.
Nor was his head disproportionate and small. وَسِيمٌ قَسِيمٌ. Proportionate and delicate, mm-hmm. Finely made, a specimen of a creation. في عينيه دعج. In his eyes there was a contrast.
Brother, females, how many females now feel in love? Tell us more.
The dark was immensely dark. The white was excessively white. وفي أشفاره وطف. And his eyelashes were long.
Stop. His eyelashes what? Brother, we reached the point we are describing the eyelashes of the beloved Prophet of Allah. And that supposedly will make us believe that Muhammad is a prophet of God. You know, what this famous actor, Alain Delon, the Lulu, he must be God. Always I wanted to have a prophet like that. How we know a prophet, he is a prophet or not? This is a serious question. How we know if a prophet is a prophet, he should have long eyelashes. And the Muslim, they keep going in the explanation. They say to you that the prophet, he have the power of 40 men of heaven, which means 4,000 men, insects. All of this to describe Muhammad. And look, we don't worship Muhammad. And who can guarantee that Muhammad even looked like that? Tell us more, brother.
فارهي وطف, and his eyelashes were long. وفي صوته صهل, and in his voice was a natural echo.
Brothers and sisters, today I'm going to show you the natural echo. I have my voice. Because I'm a prophet, I'm going to show you the echo, which proves that I am a prophet. If somebody don't have echo in his voice, he is not a prophet. There's certain things we have to find in a prophet. He have to have echo. He have to have eyelashes. He have to nice belly button. He have to have nice legs. His voice have a natural echo. So when Muhammad reads the Quran, he says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, heem. Alhamdulillah, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, heem. What the heck is that, man? I'm getting dizzy with this. Tell us more, brother. Oh, let us skip this garbage. You know, there's a part where I like most on this video. He described how sexy he is. Sexy Muhammad, come on, sexy Muhammad. Who is more sexy than Muhammad? We have to admit. The whole video is about how sexy Muhammad is. So now there's a guy, he was walking in the street at night. And then he looked at the moon. Look, the moon is coming in the background.
Rasulullah, Anas ibn Malik says, I came out one night.
This guy is having an orgasm, literally. Look, you are describing Muhammad doing that. Okay, so you were coming in the street at night, and what happened, brother?
I came out one night, that was the full moon night.
Yeah. And look how emotional he gets. Look at the emotional. Look at the emotion of, you know, he's losing his voice. He cannot talk no more. He's getting so emotional because he's so sexy. Look, he will tell you a story, even though he repeated the story a million times before, but he's getting so emotional because the prophet's face is so hot, so sexy. Tell us, brother. And don't forget to put some tears in your eyes because so good to be true. He cannot talk. See, he put his hand up and he want to tell you now how the prophet's face look like. He's out of words. It's not easy. Trust me, it's not easy. Put yourself in his shoes or in his panty.
And I looked at the moon, and in the desert, understand, the moon is an awesome sight. Uh-huh. It is smooth. It is radiant. It is clear. Uh-huh. It is gentle. Uh-huh. Compared to the scorching sun at which they are used to. So the moon was the epitome of beauty. Uh-huh. So he says, I came out at a full moon night and I looked at the moon.
Stop. This guy is reporting a true story, brother. It was dark at night, very dark. The moon is in the sky, brother. The guy, he looked at the moon. And here were the
And journey. I saw it, beautiful, handsome. So I said,
what? The moon was beautiful, handsome. This religion have a thing for everything. The moon was handsome. Okay, I got it.
Looked at the moon and I saw it, beautiful, handsome. So I said, let me go see if the moon is more handsome or my prophet.
Now I have a decision. Today I'm going to go and check. I will compare. I will do an unboxing in YouTube. I will unbox the moon for you, brother, and I will unbox Prophet Muhammad. And we will see how much the power of light. Who is more LED? LED is better. Today we will do a scientific study to see exactly how many luminous the moon have and how many limousine the prophet have. Lemoness and limonazine, what is that? I mean, who care, man? This is Islam. You can say whatever you want. As long as you are praising Muhammad, just throw it there. They will love it.
Handsome. So I said, let me go see if the moon is more handsome or my prophet is more handsome. Let me see if that is more beautiful or the prophet is more beautiful.
Did you see, did you hear the word beautiful? I mean, aren't they ashamed? The beautiful Muhammad? Okay, I will make my coming video called Beautiful Muhammad, the pretty Muhammad. Our topic, the pretty Muhammad. Beautiful? We are talking about a man. The beautiful Muhammad. Okay.
It's more beautiful, or the prophet is more beautiful. So I went and I saw him standing afar. So I looked at his face, and I looked at the moon, and I looked at his face, and I looked at the moon, and I looked at his face, and I looked at the moon.
Stop, man. What happened exactly? I look at his face, I look at the moon, I look at his face, I look at the moon, I look at his face, I look at the moon, I look at his face, I look at the moon, I look at his face, I look at the moon, I look at the face, and I look at the moon. Excuse me? I mean, shouldn't Muhammad so bright right away? We do not need more than two looks. You are insulting the Prophet now. If I am there, I will make Muhammad look from the first look. I mean, when? You are insulting the Prophet, brother. The guy, he looked 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times at the moon at Muhammad to see which one is more shiny. He needed 10 times to find out shame. He should find out from the first look. I mean, how in the world you do that? You just insulted the Prophet of Allah. I mean, even how in the world the guy, he have to look twice, or thrice, or thrice, or five, sir, or seven size, or 10 eyes. Shouldn't Muhammad win the competition from the first look? What kind of a companion he is, this companion? Shame on you. Prophet Muhammad should win immediately. We do not need even to look at the moon, you idiot. The moon himself was looking at the Prophet. And the moon, he said, look at me. I'm out of light compared to this man. He's so white. So handsome. I don't know really what to say. But I have a feeling that Muhammad, he was way more than just a prophet for the Muhammad. I don't know if you agree with me or not. Tell us more, brother.
At the moon, and I saw it, beautiful, handsome. So I said, let me go see if the moon is more handsome or my prophet is more handsome. Let me see if that is more beautiful or the prophet is more beautiful. So I went and I saw him standing afar. So I looked at his face. And I looked at the moon, and I looked at his face, and I looked at the moon, and I looked at his face, and I looked at the moon, and he said, Wallahi, he was more handsome than the moon.
I picked to the beat, walking down the street in my new the freak, yeah. This is how I roll, animal print pants out of control. It's Red Food with the big ass bra, and like Bruce Lee, I got the clout, yeah. Girl, look at that body.
What is that? This is a song.
That is just the look of your Rasul. Aisha radiallahu anha says, I was sewing with the needle. My needle dropped in the dark. I couldn't find it. I said, Ya Rasul, I can't find it. He moved his face close, and I swear, out of the radiance of his face, I found my needle.
Muhammad is a flashlight. Aisha at dark, she cannot find things. She asked the Prophet to move his face, and because his face is so white and so bright, she was able to find the needles in the dark.
Girl, look at that body. I work out. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body.
You have to admit that Muhammad is sexy, and you know it, right? Right? Muslims, what is the point of this video? He is sexy and you know it? What is that, man?
I'm sexy and I know it.
Stop there. Aisha, she was able to find the needle by asking the Prophet to move his face toward the spot in the ground. That's way above what I can handle. And now we have to admit, the Prophet was so sexy. Oh, hold on. I thought the Quran saying that Allah, he did plastic surgery to fix the breast of the Prophet. So how he was so sexy and Allah is fixing his breast? Huh? The first plastic surgery done for a man was not for a man from Thailand. It was for a man from Arabia. Read the verse with me, brother. Where is the verse? Hold on. Let me go, hold on. A prophet who Allah did the plastic surgery for his chest. Have we not caused the bosom to delight? Maybe this translation is wrong, you know. This is Biktar. Let us see a different one. Hilali and Khan. What? Have we not opened your breast for you? What? Allah, he opened the breast for Muhammad. What does that mean? Change translation, because this guy, I don't know, it's confusing me. Maybe better translation we can get. Yusuf Ali. Have we not expanded the breast? What? Allah, he did a boobie surgery for the Prophet. Sorry, I cannot show you pictures of boobie now. That would be inappropriate. But this is what it's fit for. This. I found something. We can use it. Okay. So Allah, brother, he noticed that the boobies of the Prophet are not in good size. So Allah expanded his breast. Look how Allah is busy. Allah is making surgery to clean his chest, to clean his belly. Allah is storing a dish of wisdom. Allah is storing a dish of faith. Allah is fixing the breast of Muhammad, expanding his breast. Allah is sending through 12 months verses to cure Muhammad from bewitched. I mean, this man Muhammad, he made Allah so busy. I feel sorry for Allah, honestly. I mean, this guy, he was keeping Allah so occupied. Surgery after surgery after surgery to fix him. Huh? And then, and we removed the burden. The burden of Muhammad was in his bosom, his breast. You know what? I know it. That why women they have breast? You think about it. Obviously, because they have a burden there. So Allah, he expanded the breast of Muhammad. In the same time, he removed from inside the breast the burden. And he put silicones, obviously. That's deep. plastic surgery is haram? This guy is saying plastic surgery is haram. So why Allah he did? Isn't it Allah cutting the chest of Muhammad, installing a dish of wisdom, a dish of, this is plastic surgery? Isn't it this verse in the front of you is a plastic surgery? What are you talking about? So what we were reading all the last 2 hours about your prophet, the angel cutting his chest and installing a dish of wisdom, a dish of faith in his chest. And now you are coming back to me, says to me, plastic surgery is haram. And no, it's not. Let me ask you, what is the reason plastic surgery is haram? The one who said the plastic surgery is haram. Maybe, a Muslim, who can help us? Why plastic surgery is haram? Well, my Skype is off now. We have enough for today with quarters and stupidity. Why plastic surgery is haram? Any Muslim can tell me? Is not covered by insurance. Who care about this insurance now? What those guys are talking about? Hey, hello. This is a topic about religion, not about insurance. Nothing is covered by insurance. You see, insurance companies, the only good thing about them, they take your check. When something happens, they don't know you. They will find 1 million excuses not to cover you. So all those who practice buying insurance, they are fooling themselves, especially in America. That's why they send you like a 100 pages in a small, tiny letter so you cannot read them. And nobody complained in the Congress. You see, have you ever heard of such a contract? They send you a contract nobody can read. It's haram because it's changing how Allah made you. Adam, that's deep. Adam, from now on, brother, I'm going to make you an admin when the chat is closed, which means when I'm not live on air. Guys, look what Adam, he said, and this is showing us the ignorance and the stupidity of Islam. Plastic surgery is haram because doing that, you are changing how Allah made you. So why do you circumcise the man? And why you do circumcise the women? Are you there? As long as changing the way Allah made you is haram. So why you are doing circumcision? Didn't Allah make you the way you are? Idiot. This is my problem with those who speak to me. I cannot find somebody have an intelligence level to talk to. No, people don't think. People, they throw things, you know. Allah, he want to keep you because this is how Allah, he made you. But you Muslim, you don't keep the man how he was made. You don't keep the woman how she was made. You go far, even circumcised, to cut the whole thing of the woman. Didn't your prophet, he made his hair red? You want to be red, pretty, blondie? Will Allah make you have a gray hair? Keep it a gray hair. See the hypocrisy? So when they want, it is haram. When they want, it's okay. As long as Muhammad did it, it's fine. When Allah, he cut the chest of Muhammad, installed dishes, and this is plastic surgery. This is adjustment. This is adjustment. Inserting something inside the body of a human being is what the plastic surgery do. Plastic surgery, they don't make you new, have a new breast. They just push some cushions and silicone and etc. Here we go, your prophet, he got that. Well, we are not the one who's making excuse saying you don't change how God made you. For us, we get circumcised because God said that to the in the Bible. So if you don't want to change the way Allah is, so you should not obey anyone who says to you, change the way Allah he made you. Isn't it Muhammad? He put eyeliner 3 times. He colored his hair. Do Muhammad use sugar to take hair from his body? Isn't this a change in the way you look like? How Allah made you? Allah made the man with hair in his body. Why you take it off? And why a prophet of God? He used sugar to remove hair from his let us see. Read carefully with me, but I want to see if I can offer it in English first. If Allah, He gave you hair in your chest or around your private part or in your legs, Muhammad, He used to take hair from all his body. Here we go. He began with his private area, coating it with hair, removing, etc., and his wife, you know, and then he do all his body. All his body. Muhammad, he shaved hair from all his body by sugar. This is what girls do in the Middle East. There's no man who do that. It's a shame in the Middle East to do that for a man. Everybody know that. Only women, they do such a thing. This man, who is he have time for hair in his body? Why? What for? It's an insult for me. Maybe some people in Europe, they do that. But for me, it's an insult to take hair from my body. Why? Why don't you do that? And we look like a girl? What, Muhammad, you want to look pretty? He's going to go in the bikini in the beach? So how we should not change the way Allah, He made you, and then you do all of this? He color his hair red. He take the hair off his body. He want to be like, look like a girl. He do circumcision, plastic surgery for his chest. Crazy stuff. Anyway, if there is Muslim would like to call us and speak to us, maybe the next time. For now, I think we have enough. We are here for more than 4 hours total. Don't forget to download my videos because I don't keep them. People, they ask me later, where is the video? Why come I cannot find it, my friend? If you care, download it. If you don't care to download, subscribe to those who download my videos because they copy, they download, they post it there. So always you can search for the same title or something similar. And let's say after a week, this video is gone. Search in YouTube the last month or last week for the same title. You will find it posted by many places. No, Adam, sorry, I have to go already. It's 4 hours already. You know, I'm not really tired of talking as much. I'm tired from sitting. You know, I hated to sit for long. It's not comfortable and it's not healthy. And sitting and looking at the screen for 4 hours is not a good thing. Anyway, maybe next time, Mr. Adam, you are welcome to call us when we go live on air. All right? And we will be happy to hear you. Get ready. All right? Quality of life video. My friend, there's nothing to talk about there. I don't know what to do, you know? I mean, and you know, I notice when you talk to people about personal stuff, they get offended. People get offended because I'm a person who say things as it is, you know? I don't sugarcoat things. So maybe it's not a good idea. Always, you know, in life you have to make choices, and obviously Islam is a bad, very bad choice for anyone, because Islam, the first thing it does, it kill your brain. It doesn't allow you to think, because thinking is not allowed in Islam. Questioning is forbidden. Chapter 5 verse 101 says, ask not questions of things which made plain for you. Why? Verse number 502 explain, because if you do that, you will leave the faith, and if you do that, we will kill you. So Islam is very clear in that. It's a religion where nothing there makes sense. In the same time, you cannot question what does not make sense. The stupidity of Muhammad is intelligence, if you are a Muslim. Muhammad says stupid things, he is amazing still. Muhammad, he says something against history, against science, against, it's okay, Muhammad is genius. Don't ever dare to question Muhammad. And if you question, we kill you. As simple as that. And if you question, you leave Islam. As simple as that. But if you are asking questions, which is silly, as an example, brother, is it okay to eat ice cream with my fiancé? That is welcome question. Stupid question. Brother, is it okay to shave under my arm? That is a very good question. Brother, is it okay that I was having sexual intercourse with my wife and a drop of her milk drop in my mouth? Has she become a sister now? Those questions are very welcome. I remember once a Muslim woman, she called a Muslim TV station. I wish at that time I have a software to record or something. Obviously, she is making fun of the sheikhs. She said, Salaam alaikum, you know, like in a very like a feminine voice. The two sheikhs started drinking water like non-stop. Walaikum salam, sister. She said, I have a question, please. Sure, sister. I'm very beautiful, and when I take off my clothes, shake in front of the fish tank, my sister told me that the fish, they start shaking. The sheikh, he look at the second sheikh, and the second sheikh look at the first sheikh, and they grab the water. Okay, sister. I think, sister, the first, alhamdulillah, bismillah ar-rahman ar-rahim, alhamdulillah, sister. First, sister, we advise you, sister, not to take off your clothes in front of the fish tank, because those fish, they are a male genie and they are looking at a beautiful body. You should see the guy who was saying it. The woman, she said, okay, but this is the only room I have in the house. The guy, he said to her, okay, sister, he can't even talk no more. He said, okay, why you don't cover the fish tank with the blanket? Because, sister, those genie, they are looking at your body and doing something. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. I mean, the sister, she is calling, and millions of people watching the TV stations, satellite TV stations, telling them how beautiful, sexy she is, and the fish, brother, masturbating when she see, when they see her taking off her clothes. I mean, come on, put yourself in the shoes of those fish. You are a fish in a tank, and beautiful girl taking off her clothes in front of you. And the sheikh confirmed those fish are having a genie. They are male genie, not lesbian. You have to be honest here. He did not even think about lesbian fish. No. They are male genie, and they are looking at your beautiful, poor body, sister. And this crazy woman, she is making fun of them. You see her voice, unbelievable. It's like a sex movie. I don't want to make the sound she is doing because it's embarrassment. This is what they do. Islamic TV programs. Question and answer. Brother, can my wife, when she is praying, show her toes? Brother, Prophet said, right away the sheikh is volunteering. He have an answer. Ask him how Allah sit in the chair. Don't ask. How Allah look like? Don't ask. Allahu alam. How Allah go up and down? Allahu A'lam. Any question? Allahu A'lam. Ask silly question, all of them A'lam. All of them, they have knowledge. But anyway, we learn things. If you are a person who have a fish at home, please take a note. Those fish are looking at your wife when she take off her clothes. I mean, come on. You don't want that to happen to you, do you? Hey, brother, I have a cat. Same. Muslims believe that genie can be inside anything and he have sex with Muslim women. If you search right now for sex with genie, you will find endless articles made by Muslims. You might think I'm joking. I'm not. Sex with jinn. Muhammad, he told them, they, you know, they have sex with you. So it's not like a... Someone told him a jinn have sex with you. Look at this topic, man. Islamweb.net. The scholar, brother, differ about the opinion regarding human having sexual intercourse with genie. Some of them deny it, some of them confirm it. Anyway, brother, you should turn to Allah. Look, where is the answer? The answer, yes or no? Stupidity is amazing. Oh boy. Okay. Let us see. Different website. Hold on. Can a jinn have sex with my wife? Look at this guy. This guy, he can't sleep. This guy, he woke up in the middle of the night. He went to the internet. And now he need the question to be answered now by the sheikh. Can a jinn have sex with my wife? For sure she can have. I mean, look at her. I mean, come on, Abdul. Not only a jinn, he can. He will invite his friends. Can a jinn have sex with my wives? And here he's quoting the hadith. The prophet says, when a man have intercourse with his wife and he does not say the name of Allah, the jinn coils around his urethra, around his penis, and do intercourse with him, beside him. This is a hadith. Prophet saying so. If the prophet, he says so, it's true. Al-Hakim al-Turmudhi. Hadith number, Ibn Jarir, At-Tabari, Tafsir, blah, 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 narrated, blah, 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 Mujahid said, blah, 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 blah. When a man have intercourse, and he don't say in the name of Allah, the genie, brother, the genie, he will round himself around your penis. The first condom can be recognized. Well, a black dog, you contact Zakir Naik and ask him, Christian Prince is making fun of the genie having sex with the Muslim women. Let him answer us. Jinn can be human too? Okay, jinn can be human too. Yeah, and can be angel. You know, your prophet, he have an angel, he came to him, it's called Al-Abyad, but he was a genie, right? And he was shaitan, and alhamdulillah, and he gave him satanic verses. What a messed up fiction, stupid religion. All perfect to Allah. So after a few days of this question and without proper answer, I decide to gather some reference, brother. Look at this friend here. Yes, the hadith is authentic. Okay, brother. So anyway, the conclusion, yes, your wife, she can be boom boom by a genie. Actually, if you have my book, Sex and Allah, you will see a guy who opened the door of the bedroom and his wife, she was doing something. And he claimed, actually, I don't know which number is that. He claimed that he saw a fire around her, you know. Now, the sheikh, he told him, the reason there's a fire there, brother, because she is having sex with the genie. Have you ever heard of a woman's private part caught in fire? Because the Prophet says genie are made of fire. So that makes sense. The guy, he went there to have sex with this woman, and her bushes is dry. So he cut her bushes in fire. I better stop here, otherwise we might die laughing, and you guys will go crazy. So I want to say thank you for being here. May the Lord bless you. Don't forget to download the video. I don't keep it for long. And I will see you soon again. Christ is Lord. Islam is a dummy, made by the dummy. And as much you try to defend, as much you look like a dummy. Trust me on that. Watch all the videos we have before. And those who say debate me, call me next time I go. I'm already more than 4 hours here. Next time we go live on air, you're welcome to call me. And Ante will see you again. May the Lord bless you. Have a great time with your family, your friends. And don't forget to not to let your wife take off her clothes in the front of the fish tank. It's dangerous. Take care. Warning time.